Hey, my trendies, trendy tribe. I can't even get the order right. Hey, my trendies, trendsetters, and my trendy tribe. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let me know if you can hear me. Y'all, we came from the gym. I'm hype. It's just a cool day in the sense of like the vibe. It's a hot day with the weather a little bit. Sound check, Annette said, yes, she can hear me. Okay. So the new way we do this is once this video I'm about to play ends, then I have to stop my greetings. And I'll put a timestamp so y'all can skip the greetings if that's not something you like to do. Don't worry. It'll be in the comment section. Okay, let's do this. Let me see. Oh, don't start. Don't start yet. Hold on. Okay, here we go. Who was it? Gloria Williams, first in the building. Hey, Gloria. Hey, lovely Linda Gamble, one of the hardest working mods on YouTube. Hey, Pink Queen. Hey, Sweet Rose. Hey, Olivia Schenkel. My Unisys, uppity unicorn is in here. She's my cerebral sis, also a content creator. Hey, Crystal Gal from Barbados. I hope you are catching this live too, Crystal Gal. She be supporting me on my workouts and everything. Hey, Lizzie Wheeler. Beautiful Joyce Miles has made it in here. Paper Chase 22, Lori Harrison. Purple Unicorn, Miss Lady One with the Virgo lips. Hey, Creole Girl. Hey, Lizzie Wheeler. Stephanie Sanon. Hey, okay, at work, can't stay. I got you, Stephanie. Thank you for dropping by. My middle sis, Journey to Jasmine, is here. Shout out to the bourgeoisie. That's right. Jasmine, I saw your post that you were with little sis. That's so cute. Can't wait to see y'all's videos if y'all post anything or pictures. Hey, Nyla. And Jasmine is a content creator, too. Hey, Miss Tina in the bushes today. Let me see. I see y'all saying hey to each other. Hey, Bama girl with my, she got my little cup, my art on the cup. I appreciate the support, Bama girl, because Bama girl got a couple of my things now. I appreciate you. Hey, D, good morning. Connie Jones, Thee. I like saying Thee. Hey, Darcelle Ayers, Anj Roughhouse. Come on. Donna Colley Howe. I said, hey, the sound check, Annette. Hey, Kim Jones, Aries 66. We got Mama B's, 32 Shots Photography, JD, Muted Expressions, Yvette Bell, Daphne Brown, Tamara Allen, Josie Kurtz. Hi. Hey, Helen Lane. Great Friday to you too. Liddell is here. Hey, Now Later Mango. What up, though? Are you from Michigan too, Now Later Mango? Hey, Mama Capricorn. I'm saying too light, not too for me, but just in general, because I know that's what they say out in Michigan. What up, though? Hey, Cass Womack. Let's see. Yes, you love you. Mellow Nation stopping by and supporting you. Thank you, Cass. Hey, Steph M. Bridget from the 502. Oh, it stopped. Okay. I got to stop there. Okay. All right. Okay. Alpha MC and Duchess, I see y'all. All right. Let me stop because I just keep going all day. Okay. Let me see here. What are we going to start with? Hold on. How am I going to do this? Did I put this in the, hold on, y'all. I got too many things going on. I'm just so excited to be here, y'all. I'm sorry. I'm getting it together. I did come from outside. Shout out to y'all that just be sending encouragement for the workouts, because it be brutal, you know? Especially when you're not someone that's just like, oh, I love to work out, because that's not me. Oh, okay. From New York City. Brooklyn. Okay, Brooklyn. Yes. Okay. We're going to start with Instagram. We got a lot of Instagram, y'all. We have a lot of Instagram. So let me share my screen. Let's see. First, if you didn't see it, I'm going to share it because I know I'm cracking myself up and it might not be that funny, but I cracked myself up. So therefore, we're going to look at it together. Y'all. So y'all know when Milichun posted her screenshot. And yes, I heard it might be back open. Okay, I know, but I don't care. This will forever be funny for me. Okay. Thank you, Donna. But I was in there playing around. I used to post all the time to TikTok. And then once I created this channel and it wasn't my art channel, I wasn't doing as many TikToks, but y'all, and my little sis Danny is in here now too. Danny, I will say you have inspired me to get back and being creative on creating the memes and everything, because if y'all go visit Danny's page, and hold on, because I know she's in here. Hold on, I gotta go. I should know, but I just have to type your name and I find you. As Told by Danny, that's her Instagram name. As Told by Danny, she's doing some great Melometer memes and everything. So y'all, this one, let me get the sound for you. This was me on how I pictured the T Squad, which I know there's not a real T Squad. But if there was one, this is how I pictured them being when they saw that sign about Black being temporarily closed.
Oh, no. No.
Okay, that's one of many that I have. I can't play the other one with Wanda, but shout out to Wanda. Okay, so there's Wander, you know, that's Tisha Mama, but there's a trendy name to Wanda. She said, can you redo your thing, but put Money Long song to it, that twin, Where Have You Been? So I'm gonna have to keep it on mute, but this is the one she was talking about. Hold on, where is that? Oh, it's been a while. Has it been that long? Here it go. This one, I can't play the sound, but she said, can you play Twin, Where Have You Been with this one? I'm like, yes, I will recreate it and put that song on there. Danny said, well, I guess it was a little close. Yes. Okay. Let me stop. Okay. I have so many notes. Y'all, this is going to be an avid elementary weekend for me and Mr. Trending, because we have to catch up. We had to resubscribe to Hulu so we could support Abbott Elementary, because Hulu they got out of hand with raising their prices. I'm tired of them. But we got it to just go ahead and make sure we watch Abbott Elementary. I can't wait. They said Keegan-Michael Key is going to be on there at some point. If you saw his skits when it was Key and Peele and he would butcher those kids' names like Jaquelin instead of Jacqueline, Aaron. I was like, is he gonna play this character on Abbott Elementary? I don't know. I'll watch it even if that's not his character. I'll watch it. I don't care. Then we have Cree Summer is apparently gonna be on Abbott Elementary. And then there's some other names. Oh, I forgot. Oh, did I say Tatiana Ali might be on there? I think Tatiana Ali might be on there, but I'm getting in there this weekend so I can catch up. D's that I don't believe they open. It's a fake video or stage. D, let me tell you. Yeah, we're going to wait and see. That's what I'm going to say. Because my thing is, of course, there's two things. Either you're doing damage control and it's like now people notice you weren't open. So you're going to push, you're going to try to just go ahead and do it and be open. Or you posting older videos or you open temporarily. So then you think everybody look away and you got to close again. I don't know. But yeah, it's weird. It's weird either way. Because D, I'm kind of with you, D. I don't know for sure, but I'm kind of with you, D. Yes, Abbott is so funny, y'all. Kree is awesome. I wanted to show y'all, and I don't know how much they're going to do before they tell me it's a copyright thing, but I don't know if y'all understand how many voices Kree Summer has been for our, I'll say young adult life and some childhood, depending on how old you are or young you are. Kree Summer has voiced so many doggone characters. Got to give her flowers. So I've had something bookmarked for a while, but I don't know how to show it to y'all because I'm like, it's still going to be copyrighted material, but oh my God, Kree Summer is just wonderful. I love her. I love her so much. And then y'all know they had just finished doing an HBCU 10 city tour with a different world reunion. That was awesome. Good morning. Good morning. Yes. Kree is the voice on your childhood. I thought, yeah, Danny, even if you don't know, oh, she was in there. She was in something you were watching. so we got to go through and give her flowers one day for sure. I've had it bookmarked forever. I don't know how I'm going to play it, but we got to figure it out. Maybe it'll have to be a free. It'll be free. I won't make it members only, but I'll just have to do it through StreamYard and off of YouTube. How about that? So I'm going to get that link ready for y'all one day so y'all know it's coming. Go ahead and have your thing ready to go. And then we can go watch it together on StreamYard to see all of her voices instead of having to worry about YouTube and their copyright issues. I think that's how we can do it. We can still do it. And it can still be free. We can do it together. Okay. That's where we go. No, B. They can't. They can't be. Yes. Favorite cartoons. I see y'all. Nickelodeon, Rugrats. Yes. I see y'all. I was too old to watch it, but y'all, I was still watching cartoons, but I just didn't get it. I didn't get to get into the, what's it called? The Spy Kids Next Door, the Kids Next Door. She voiced one of the kids with a number. It was a lot. Kree, we're going to have to go through your resume. She is so wonderful. Okay. Let's see here. Y'all, this is me from, let me find it real fast. This is me when Melody comes into my chat. Did I download it? Oh, you lucky. Okay, I didn't get it yet. It's in my phone draft, so I can't show y'all yet. But that one, just look out for that one, because that's really how I be behind the scenes when Melody comes into my live. I'll get it to y'all. Charnita's World is tonight. Charnita's World is tonight. We have a watch along with the Trendy Tribe. So if you are a member of Patreon or on the YouTube side, I will have a link drop soon, today soon, because it drops because we got to watch it tonight. So I will have a link dropped so you can just tap that link and we can do our watch along together. We have fun. We be in the comments. I highlight comments just like I'm highlighting them now. You know, it's a nice way to watch something that you enjoy together with other people. So please be looking out for that link. It'll be on the membership tab and on Patreon if you are a patron. And yeah, we just be getting together, chilling. What color outfit are you? Okay. I don't want to say too much, but I know you would think I'd be in a bright color on how my personality is, right? For the actual event, because I went so eclectic, I chose to still be in mostly black because the style that I went for is so, to me, it might be a little out there for a black tie event that I was like, oh, I can't chance it with the color too, because then I'm probably not going to look like I was even trying to do a black tie at all. So let me tell y'all this. Let me tell you how much, first of all, Queen Sheba. Was like, hey, I didn't realize that I actually need a partner to help me get into this outfit. So, do you mind if I come by your room to get help? So, Queen Sheba graciously will let me come to her room, and she'll even know how many pieces she actually has to help me with. Because I think she got to help me with the shoes, the outer garment I can't name because I'm trying not to give away what it looks like yet. Even my down to y'all, I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm just this is we're oversharing right now. Even my bra, I'm gonna need a little bit of help with y'all. Oh my gosh, because the style is just so it's not like maybe you'll look at like, oh, it's not that different, but I know when it comes to black tie, I'm like, oh, I'm pushing it. I'm pushing it. Hey, CC, I'm sorry. Yeah, I think I need to take that down. I didn't realize I had two lives up. I had saw that, but it was like I had to get my butt in here. So, but thank you for catching the one that I'm on. Hey, sweet sis, 41 fit. How are you? Part of the mod squad and a content creator. And Danny is also in the mod squad. Thank y'all for everybody that's here. What? Okay, we're talking about the outfit. So Queen Sheba, thank you. She's gonna help me because Mr. Trina was like, okay, I'm helping you now as you try on this outfit. How are you gonna get into this outfit when you're actually there? I was like, oh my god, that's a good question. I don't be thinking about the little stuff. It's just like, make sure you have an outfit. Oh my gosh. So yeah, so shout out to Queen Sheba. She's gonna help me. Joint to Jasmine don't know. She probably gonna be part of the help too, be helping me. So Jasmine, I know you in here, so just so you know, you might be helping me too. Because I know I'm gonna see you. You're right, Patricia, you're very, very close to some things because you're right. You never go wrong with black, and most of my outfit consists of black, and there is some spandex involved, but it's not obvious, but there's some spandex involved in there. So yes, Patricia, you're right there, Patricia. Thank you. Yes, I hope so. I got the approval nod from Mr. Trendon, aka my pageant dad. So that's always a plus, you know. And then he also was like, don't forget about your outfits while you're just there that weekend. So I do have a couple of springy, cute little tops that I got for when I'm out and about. Y'all, also, I do think this is a thing. When you go to the airport, if you are able to be comfortable and be cute, try to do that because they do be treating you different when you dress like you care. I don't know what it is. I ain't saying you got to, but I'm just letting you know there is a marked difference of how you are treated if you look a little, you dress a little cute at the airport. I'm just letting you know. I'll be learning about tips I ain't never known. I just be feeling like extra things be happening on them days. Find something cute but comfortable because comfort is first. What else we got? Let's see here. Oh my gosh. And I'm gonna get to see. Okay. So I believe, first of all, Malcolm's the esthetician out in Dallas-Fort Worth. He's over in my hometown. Malcolm, shout out to you. He is so sweet. He is so sweet. You know, he uses 7th Avenue products for his clients. And hold on, I got to go get the name because I don't, you know, I just go to Instagram. Hold on, let me see. Let me take this down real, real fast because I just gotta show y'all Malcolm's page. P&2 Ross has actually physically been there before. Shout out to P&2 Ross. But I'm going to get to meet Malcolm, first of all. And I'm pretty excited. Because he seems so chill. And oh my gosh, I don't want to say too much, but I'm excited to meet him. Jay Taylor's going to be there. This is Malcolm's page, y'all. This is Malcolm DxO, and then his actual page is DFW Aesthetics. So I'll go to that one too. Let me see. DFW Aesthetics, and he does use 7th Avenue products. It's a whole experience, right? Kim Jones says, Trending, that's so true. Delta tells the employees to dress when we travel. Okay. Yes. I'm telling you. Okay. 32 shots. I'll be cute on my flight from Wisconsin to ATL. So I'm going to see you at the event, 32 shots. You know you're going to have to give me your YouTube name to, you know, to let me know. But yes, y'all, I'm telling you, there's something different. A nice sport jacket and some nice jeans, fresh iron blouse, and your jewelry. Patricia, it's so crazy. Yes. That, now there's other ways too. That's one style because I know people are going to be like, that's not my style. And I get it. I'm just letting you know there's some different ways to do it. But the experience changes. It just changes. People be asking questions just to offer you things and just, I don't know. It's different. It's different. It's almost, and I have two experiences because I've had to travel in military uniform. So of course there's a different type of treatment there. And then I've traveled really, really laid back and like travel cute. And it's just some differences. It's some differences. Okay. So yeah, this is Malcolm's page. He's going to be there. Let me show y'all Malcolm's actual face too. So y'all know, y'all already know, but I'm just still going to show you. Is this going to show his face? When I go home to Dallas, I am just like putting it out there that I'm going to do my best. I'm going to be booking an appointment and I'm going to go. I want to be there. I want this experience. This is P&2 Ross right here. That's P&2 Ross. Hold on.
It was phenomenal. You have to come see
now. All right. And the products we use today?
Amazing. Absolutely amazing. My Facebook and feels amazing.
All right, so thanks to 7th Avenue, and thank you to our 7th Avenue beauty for today.
Oh,
yes, shout out to my sis, P2 Ross. P2 Ross been with me almost basically from the beginning of this channel. Let me see. Hey, Sandra P. Your approach can make a big difference as well, Brittany. I totally agree. Duchess says, do you have all your jewelry? Duchess, it comes in today. The jewelry comes in today. Okay. The jewelry also helps me to bring it back to like showing like, yes, I know this is a black tie event. so yes, Duchess, my jewelry, when it comes in today, I will have that. And then it will be complete. That's it. The jewelry is the last piece of the outfit. We tried on the shoes yesterday. I got two options just in case the first one didn't work out like I was hoping. Everything fits like it's supposed to, because we had to do a couple trial and errors on that. You know, we changing sizes over here. So got that. I actually need to start going ahead and throwing some things in the suitcase that I know I won't need till I get there, because I'm trying not to be a procrastinator this time. I'm trying to actually be prepared to travel. I have an early morning flight because I want to enjoy my day of that Friday coming in and not be rushing. So I just want to have everything ready. I just don't want to be stressed about certain things. Oh, purple unicorn. God dang it. Let me rest this. I ain't got no purple unicorn. See, this is why you start. This is why you talk things out. Purple. I do not have a purse. What was I thinking? I'm so casual most days that I wear like this fitness band that holds my ID card. I forgot. Okay. You can do it. Just start. Yo, if all else fails, start with Amazon. Believe it or not, there's a lot of clothes and the return policy is so easy. Start there, yo, and just go get you some ideas, or go on Pinterest first and type in a style you like, then go find that somewhere. Or half the time, Pinterest itself will link you to the store that they're showing it to you from. You got this, yo. Find your outfit. Find it. Thank you, Karen. I am so excited for this. You don't even know. What are the names of Malcolm's businesses again? Let me drop his Instagram account in here. It is DFW Aesthetics. I'm dropping his Instagram into the chat too, because then that will then link you to where you can book an appointment and everything. So yeah, Malcolm be having that natural glass skin on his clients. Look at this. Look at this. Ooh. Don't give me YouTube. Look at this. Danny said, OMG, I love purchase. I cannot get it. Purses. I'm a coach girly and I'm not ashamed. Don't be ashamed, Danny. Danny, I don't really know or do name brands like that. Like, I know of them because their names be so big, but I'm a style person first. So half the time, I don't know where the style would come from, but I know what I like. I like what I like. Yeah, a nice clutch. I'm writing it down, Patricia. I gotta have my doggone purse. What was I thinking, y'all? Resolve has beautiful dresses. Ayana says it's prom season, so there's a lot of choices out there. I look forward to meeting you too, yo. Oh, Revolve. Sorry, Revolve. Okay, Ayana, thank you so much. Hey, Big Sis Peaches and Cream. Okay. Okay. Oh my gosh. All right. Let me go back here. Do I have something else I wanted to say? So at this point, we're counting down. We're counting down because the event, it's on March 30th, and there are a few tickets left, as you can see right here as well. There was, I feel like there was like 8 tickets left the last time I heard, but there are some tickets left in case you're like, Oh, if they still had had those tickets, I still may have gone. Just so you know, there are some tickets still out there. Journey suggested, my team lead messaged me yesterday and said I was glowing. I promise 7th Avenue Beauty is the truth. Yes, sis. When I tell you, and then, okay, so the feeling of it, like my skin feels so hydrated but smooth and not like overly oily or anything like that. And I think I'm a combo. I feel like I'm a dry skin, oily skin type person. And it's, when I tell, that's why I'm, and see, this is, I have a tendency to be even more lazy because this stuff like actually stays. And so then I'm like, oh, I'm supposed to have a routine daily to use this, but then it'd be carrying me through a few days and I forget, like, oh, you're still supposed to be doing this. So yes. Teresa said, I have a zillion coach and Michael Kors. Now Later Mango said, I pray that the weather is beautiful for you all. Thank you, Now Later Mango. Yes, the weather can be bipolar. Have fun regardless. We will. We're going to make it do what it do what it do. Shout out to Shari's Reality. Let me see. Trending. God. Oh, you know what? I might, because I don't already have a scent, I've still been looking for my scent, and I almost honestly think it is the one that Jay Taylor was inspired to make that candle off of, the one that, if y'all watched my review, I was losing my mind. I feel like that's my scent, Baccarat Rouge, but I don't have Baccarat Rouge wallet right now, so instead, it might just be a light, just using Melody's, the 7th Avenue body oil and keep it moving. I don't want to rush it. Does it end at 9 or do we hang around for a while? Yo, I'm prepared to hang around. I'm going to tell you right now. I don't know how I'm going to get some tennis shoes or some other shoes in there with me because I feel like we need to be ready to hang out after the thing ends officially, yo. So be prepared just in case. I feel like, and I could have sworn Lil Sis said it too, but I feel like basically there's another after party coming. And I feel like Melody might have said that, but I don't want to put that on her in case she didn't actually say it. I can't wait to meet you too, Cricket22. We're going to tell everybody our YouTube names so I can make sure I remember y'all. Hopefully you can get an early check-in. When I travel, I usually put everything at the front door so I don't forget anything. Make sure you pack your liquids in your check baggage so no problems with TSA. Yes, ma'am, Mama Capricorn. Yes, ma'am. How I See It TV said the face wash and moisturizer combo is good. I just started using it. My skin feels soft. Yes. Yes, sis. I'm telling you. Let them know. Because, no, it really, as someone that has used Clinique and I have not been scared to kind of spend money on a good skincare product, although I still don't have a regular skincare routine. It's really, really, really good. It is really good. Girl, I'm trying to be like you, Jasmine. I ain't got there yet. Yep, the candles smell really good. They just said they hope the weather's really nice for us, but nobody said what it is. Cause you know, whatever they predict now, it's going to change. Whatever the weather person, weather.com predicts. Danny said, I'm back, y'all. Hopefully I make it over from the other link. Oh, dang. Is it really that bad? Hold on. Let me just go cancel it or put something in the chat. One second. I'm still here. I can still talk to y'all, but I didn't realize it was that bad. One second. Where is it at? That's on me. Mm-mm-mm. Let me find it. It must be this one. This is probably the culprit. I'm going to go let them know. This is the link to the live. I'm sorry. Thank you, Danny, for holding it down in there. I see you. Let me copy this link and put it in there. Y'all, and I had looked, I should have just canceled it, but now I'm gonna leave it because now I feel like I might have done too much damage. Okay. Thank you, Danny. Okay, let me see here. Alphim C says, sneaking in to say trending. Thank you for sharing your testimony about 7th Avenue hair products. I ordered it last week during the sale, received Tuesday, washed my hair that night, and my hair is so soft. Thank you, Alphim C, for coming back to tell me. Because I was like, I can't be up here just saying stuff. my 4C hair would not allow me to be over here playing with y'all. Like, I really needed to do what it needs to do to work. A great Baccarat dupe is Dossier, sis. I'm about to flood the group chat. Okay, let me know, Journey to Jasmine. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ballet flats in your purse. Charlene, I'm putting it in the list with this clutch purse that I got to get. Ballet flats it is. Ballet flats. Got it. Thank you. Good morning, Chronicles of Kim K. TOP foldable flats. I see y'all. Glitter sneakers, that's cute. Okay, let me see. Car said, I'm convinced that 7th Avenue has magical ingredients. My skin looks so clean and well moisturized to the point I don't have to wear makeup. My husband notices too. Yes, yes, that is real too. That is, I'm telling you, it's a good product. Like, if there was a blind test, I still feel like I choose it. Like, it's not a label thing. It's like, I feel different. I feel the difference. I see the difference. Oh, thank you, Danny. I'm coming in late. I'm trying to catch up to the chat. Thank you so much. Glittery foldable slippers. Let me put glitter on there too. Let me see if I can find that. Add glitter to the description. I used to model for different events. Now I only do for church events. Oh, okay, Patricia. Hey, Charlene. Okay, yo. Thank you for stopping in. Okay, y'all saying Dossier. Okay. I'm 4C and I love the hair products, body and face products. Yep. That's what I'm saying. I'll be having 7th Avenue days now. In fact, I got let me tell you what. Now, I had given it up for a year and a half to 2 years, but your girl's going back to lay down on her lash girl's table or chair, whatever it's called, to get those individual lashes. I have an appointment this next Friday. I'm getting my lashes back. Lashes were my manicure pedicure to me. Like, if I'm treating myself and I wanted a regular, like, girly thing, individual lashes are my thing. Like how a lot of people would get their nails done. Mm-mm. I say it's lashes all day. It's lashes all day. So I'm gonna tell you now, the nails are gonna be plain, but my hands are gonna be, you know, my hands are gonna be cute and dainty, whatever. But I can't do the nails. I don't know, because I don't even like dealing with press on. So it won't be painted nails for me. I'm telling you now, don't judge me. But the lashes shall be popping. A crossbody clutch, since you're not used to carrying one, because you'll leave it. Ooh, look at, you see y'all? Okay, I'll look into that. The suggestion, y'all are, this is why it says share what you're doing, because people have good suggestions. Male skincare is top notch. You didn't miss with this at all in Simone. Yes. Okay. So I got clutch purse, possibly crossbody, ballet flats to go into the clutch purse. The foldable flats possibly will be glitter. Possibly will be glitter. Okay. What else? Okay. Okay. We talked about the extra tickets. We talked about that. I want to also say thank you to the new trendies that have joined our group. And I don't mean members only. I mean, like, literally you just hit the subscribe button and you here. Welcome. Appreciate y'all coming and wanting to stay. We are close to 8K. We're closer to 8K than 7K right now. Okay. So y'all, for the ones that have been here, you know what that means. You know that means it's a giveaway coming up, right? And we have fun with the giveaways. And I learned from the last one, I'm reducing the numbers on the wheel. I think we were going to reduce it down to even like 1 to 30 or one. It was 1 to 50 or 1 to 30. It was going to be lower. That wheel was giving everybody anxiety, but it was still fun. And some of the prizes that we have done before are $10 cash apps. Always cash apps. So $10 cash apps. We have done a 7th Avenue gift card. But since I don't know if they discontinued the 7th Avenue digital gift cards. If they did, I will probably just cash app you to get something from 7th Avenue. So hopefully you'll still go to 7th Avenue. Also, I have gifted from my own Trending at Some Point store. So like, if you were like, I've been having my eye on this little Pisces or Leo little some shirt, hoodie, cup, you know, then like I get like my, basically the gift is you can pick anything from my store. So you just tell me what you want, your size, your color choice, and it comes to you. Uppity has won that way, I believe. I've had a few people win that way and they get their things. I try to make sure and of course I keep my email open in case anything goes wrong. So you can tell me if you didn't get it, because I want to make sure you get your things. The mods be helping me because they be screenshotting the cash apps for me to make sure I don't miss anybody. Giveaways are fun. Okay. Giveaways have been really, really fun. So hopefully y'all join me. We also did did we do a $50 cash app too? Like, we just be having fun with the giveaways. And I do giveaways based on two things. I had to bring in the wheel with the numbers for the people that's like, look, I don't type that fast. Okay. I don't know what you're doing, Trinity, but this we need something else. So the wheel came in for the people that don't type fast. And then there's trivia for people that just be knowing the things and they do type fast. So we have different ways for people to win. It's really, really fun. Yeah, it was a lot. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Yep. I'm a crossbody purse all day. Patricia said the individual lashes are the best because you only have to wash around them. But if you use the strips, they will come off when you get a shower. Right, Patricia. I have been on individual lashes for years, but I had taken off time to, because I mean, you know, they're not cheap. Okay. And it's a treat to myself. And I feel like, because let me tell you something else. This is just a personal thing to me. So, I am not judging anybody when I say this. I just want to say this. So I'm probably the biggest size I've ever been at in my body. Right. And one of the things I would always say is I don't want to use pampering to mask the size I'm not comfortable with. And so when I started getting bigger, I let go of getting the lashes because I was like, okay, because I don't want that to be my crutch to be like, well, I'm still cute, but I'm over here and my back hurt. So that's me. So it's not that there's a size that I'm trying to say is not a good size, but on my body, my back is like, girl, no, I don't know what you think you're doing, but this ain't what we used to. And you need to get it together. So with that stuff, I start pulling back some of the pampering things because I don't want to accidentally mask that something that'll make me feel comfortable. And then I don't do what I know I need to do. So I'm not hurting in pain. Cece said, I'm 4C and just started using 7th Avenue leave-in conditioner. I love it so far. My hair is well moisturized, but not a lot of shrinkage. Yay! I re-up on the conditioner and the oil. That oil, if you like, I can only try one thing right now, start with the oil or the mask, the deep conditioning hair mask. If you're like, look, I can't bundle right now, and that's okay, start with one of those. Yes, community is everything, Duchess. Training, I started doing my own individual cluster lashes, and baby, I love these over strips, and I'm going to have them professionally installed. Going back into the bushes, gotta earn my pay. Go ahead, Alpha C. Yes, I never could get the strips right. So I went from trying to do strips to the clusters that you're talking about. Shout out to Kiss at CVS and, you know, that brand Kiss. Sure did love them things. And then I eventually went to the individuals, but yes. And then I tried magnetic for a while, but magnetic is cute, but I don't trust them and I need that trust. Hey, Jamie. Let me see. Don't judge me if I'm in flats, because how are we going to take around the hills if there's an after party? How I see TV, I won't judge you, sis. I will not at all judge you. Let's see. April said the giveaway lives are so fun. I'd be there just to have fun and a good laugh. Yes! Did y'all see who was punking me that one time? Who punked me? Not for real, but they were playing like, I will take you to court if I don't win. I think it was Queen Wisdom. She was like, I better win something. I'm taking you to court. Hey, Joe shift changed. So yes, I'm so happy to see you in here, Joe. Tell them to change your shift back. You too, Charlene. B said, I totally get that. Thank you, Danny. I appreciate that. You know how we have our things. Brittany said, I haven't got my nails done in 2 years, but I sure will get a pedicure once a month. Yep, it's whatever. I get you, sis. I get you. I'm ticklish. I'm so bad. I can't get I can get them, but I'd be real tensed up if I get a pedicure. And then if I get a full body massage, they told me, the masseuse said, hey, when you get a full body massage, you might want to tell them just don't even touch your feet, because then you tense back up and you defeat the whole purpose of having a massage. I was like, dang, not when the masseuse got to tell me stop getting my feet massaged. I do. I be jerking around, giggling. I can't. It be so ticklish. T-Talk said, great thought process. Hence why I don't use girdles. Ah, yes. Teresa said, I tried magnetic, but it didn't feel secure. Yeah, they are cute, but they don't feel secure. Betty Boop, you got to put in the chat which brand of magnetic glue or lash liner that you're using, because I have tried Glamnetic, and then there's another one, I think that starts with an A, like Ardell or something. I don't know. And it's not doing it for me, but I think the concept of magnetic lashes are great. The struggle be real trying to stay in the fight. Yes, April. Hey, T-Talk, going back in the bushes because you at work. I know people at work making you work. The hair oil is milk or grow. Right, Janae. Brittany, yes. Hey, Sandra Sanderson. Tell them to start with your feet. That's what my daughter does. It don't matter, Makila. I get no pleasure in a foot massage. They were right. So I can just tell them to spend time on something else that really helps, like my lower back or something. I'll just like, just give me my full hour, but put it on something else, because the feet just ain't doing it for me. I will wait to meet you all at MeloCon this summer, and I will be there, Kim Jones. Don't tell my family this, because they're going to be mad if they'll be mad at me, but I did tell Mr. Trinidad. I said, if MeloCon happens the weekend of my family reunion, I'm just going to have to see my family on a non-family reunion weekend. Not missing MeloCon. I'm not trying to miss MeloCon. Brittany said, Danny nails are too dang high. I'm not paying $100 for a French tip. Girl, right. Hey, Michelle, so from Seattle. Let me see. We talked about the give. Yeah, 8K giveaway is coming up. I can't wait. It's probably, I don't know if it'll be this month, but I do feel like if it's not this month, it'll probably be in the first half of April. That's what I'm feeling like. Mel did say there'll be an after party. Thank you. I thought I saw something about dancing, Teresa. Miss the reunion. Y'all, I'm not joking. I wish I was. Oh my God, I'm not joking. I'm not joking, but I just hope it doesn't come down to that, because I really would like to go to the family reunion. MeloCon has been something like, I'm gonna see my family, y'all. Don't worry, I'm gonna see my family. We need a date. My summer is busy. I would love to go to MeloCon. Yeah, a Melody. Can we please get a date as soon as possible? Don Michelle, can we get a date as soon as possible? Mama Capricorn said, Trini, you are hilarious about your family reunion. And I'm not playing. And it's actually somewhere I want to go. Like, I actually want to do it. It's in New Orleans. Like, of course I want to go. But it's MeloCon first. I'll still pay the thing to make sure that they're not out if I have to go out. But they're going to be mad at me. I hope they don't hear this. The key to the magnetic lashes is you have to apply the coats of the liner. Wait 5 minutes. Oh, 5 minutes? I didn't wait that long. I did not wait 5 minutes. I gave them a good old 60 seconds to 90 seconds. I'm going to try it. I got a dissolve shirt ready for MeloCon. Oh, that's funny, Joe. Dissolved. Yep, that's the next thing. Look, MeloCon is actually happening because we pushed for it. So hopefully we can get a date soon. Now we got to push for dates. When is it? We start with a month. Give me a month. And then we got to drill down to the actual weekend. It's happening. Please, 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 please. let's see. Okay, y'all, we got a lot of Instagram news coming out too. Let me see. Let me get myself back together over here, because a lot of days I be forgetting that this does go out to people that don't necessarily know about me yet, and I just be in here chilling with y'all, and I enjoy that. But I also then sometimes get self-conscious after the live, like, oh my God, I should stay focused. Oh, this is Kev on stage. Let's talk about Kev on stage and his message that he had. This is a great message for content creators or anybody that's like, I'm trying to improve or I'm trying to do something and it's not hitting right. I really like this message, so I'm gonna play that. Danny gifted 5 trendy memberships. Y'all come to the watch along. Hold on, let me switch screen so I can see who it went to. Hold on 1 second. Okay, Teresa Wright. Yep, that's doggone right. It should have went to Teresa Wright. Robin Davis, Dana Marie, and Robin. Yes, Robin Davis. I totally get it. Dana Marie, sound check the thing, got a membership. Is it one more? Was that 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. Lovely Linda Gamble. Of course it should go to Linda Gamble. I thank you so much, Danny. Look, we got to go ahead. We got to welcome you in. And then I see your comment. What was the melody news? Mama Capricorn, that's why I got to stay focused. That's what we'll start with. Then I'll go to the other stuff. Thank you, Mama Capricorn. So let me welcome the new Trendy Tribe members in and some returning Trendy Tribe members. Where we at? Bring it in.
Bring it in. Starting from the bottom, now we're here.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Yes. I appreciate y'all so much. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Let me get to her Instagram first. Mama Capricorn, keeping me focused. Hold on. So... now, some of my melody news was the mimosas with melody stuff. I wanted to tell y'all about my stuff, but I do have other things. Hold on. It was, is it in my downloads that I take it over? I wanted to share what she put in. Oh my gosh, if we could just figure out. Okay, I got to put it as a cover. StreamYard. AlfMC, welcome to the Trendy Tribe. I see you. Thank you so much. I think you almost might be coming back. I don't know. I'm so used to you.
Bring it in. Starting from the bottom, now we're here.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. Let me pull up this is what Melody put yesterday in her stories. And I'm like, man, it's a lot of people that this could apply to, but I'm gonna still read it because I just want to keep up with what's going on. Because as this unfolds, we'll come back here, you know, as the season airs and as other things go on, we always can revisit our content creators to be like, oh, that's what that was about. That's when that happened. So here's one of the things. This is from Melody's stories. From yesterday morning, I believe. But it says, up and at it, y'all, and it's already been a prosperous day. Now I wonder who couldn't sleep at night for thinking about me. I'm going to stay doing good. I'm going to keep my light shining so it can keep upsetting and revealing demons. It applies to so many. It's so many at this point. It's so many that couldn't sleep because they just too worried about her business instead of their own business. But that was one I wanted to catch before it went away. So to those of y'all, not y'all, but them, to those of them that couldn't sleep, focus on your own stuff. Stop being, sorry, I got excited about something else on accident, but stop being jealous, focus on your goals, live out your goals, and people actually will come to support you when you're actually just doing those things and not being a scanner, not being spiteful, not trying to make someone else's life miserable for no reason. People do come out to support you. Like, I promise you they do. Okay. The reason I went is because I saw somewhere that, and I don't have a graphic for this, and I ain't going to her Instagram page, but I heard literally through the grapevine, because I don't know who said this, but or who put this out, but shout out to you that put it out. They said that Stormy apparently got like this 300,000 square foot warehouse, right? I don't know if, and this is because I'm hearing it third, fourth hand. I apologize because I'm about to speculate on general news that I heard. So first of all, I don't know if it's a shared space or her own space, but I'm going to say this. I don't think Stormy has still reformed and manages her money better. And the reason I'm going to say that is because was it a Porsche or a Jag? Her Jag had got temporarily repossessed last month because of a debt that got ruled in default favor of the plaintiff because she did not pay them for, I believe it was services rendered. I have a whole visual I can show y'all her cases that have come out. But, 30,000 square foot. Okay, 30,000 square foot. And I just think she really, really should figure out how to package on all that land that she has instead of keep paying and putting money in other people's pockets. Because I don't think I still don't think she manages her funds well. I was looking at, she still has the one, okay, let me put it this way. If I still had a over $1 million lien on my house, I would be focusing on how to get them people off my house, get these liens off my property, okay? That's what I would be focused on. I'm not going for no new warehouse space. I don't care what people think about what I can or can't do. I would get those liens off my house first. That's the thing first. Because that lien is still there because it's so big. It's still there. Then it was being reported by non-Melometers, because that's the first thing they try to say, that her body wax was just basically turned out to be candle wax. It started out with a great scent, some people said, but when they were repeat customers, it just turned out to be wax at that point. Beeswax, not candle wax. So I know she's skimping then. So if you're skimping, you're not in that place to do this. If people would get the stunting on the gram part out of their system, they could do so much better. But it's her. That's her. I don't know what she needs the space for. A content creator. Oh, Anonymous T. Anonymous T is the one that says something about she's getting into the body oils now. You know, it's an open market. I'm going to let it go for now. But she's getting into the body oils. She's out of the body butters and going, or body whatever it was, and going into the body oils. Okay, but that warehouse thing sounds like a bad idea, and I admit I heard it like really third hand, so I don't know much about it, but it just sounds like a bad idea. How come Stormy no longer promotes her hair products? That's a good question, because that's where her true customer base first came from, and not knowing Stormy from anybody, I heard that they were good products in the beginning. After that, I heard that it wasn't so great. Again, like everything keeps seeming to decline in quality. And I just don't understand with this warehouse space. I don't get it. Faking the funk. Yep. Let's see here. I thought she was doing the big box store anymore, or was it online? She keeps rebranding Danny. So I can't keep up with her either. I don't know what's going on, but I feel like if she still has that same mindset and she's still trying to prove Duchess, if she's still trying to prove to people she got it like that, she's not going to have it like that. And it's going to be more court cases, because you just get someone that helps you manage your money and your production the right way. Like, I don't know. I know it don't matter for me, because of course she ain't gonna like me. Cause when I tell you what, every court case I come across with her name on it, I have gone over it. So I know she don't like me. Stormy ain't making that body glaze. It's white labeled. True. Well, oh dang, it's white labeled. I was gonna say, I saw her at that packaging place. I didn't know it was white labeled, but I do know the quality had went down. Cause here's the thing. Scene where, you know how companies, what was his name? The Prophet. It was a show called The Prophet. My dad had put me on it. And so instead of like Prophet, it was called Profit. I can't remember his name, but he would always wear the little dad jeans. He was balding, but I loved his personality. And he would go saving businesses, and he would show them how to go to a packaging company, give them your formula so they can make it and stuff like that. So I figured that's what Stormy was doing. That's the benefit of the doubt I tried to give her, that she gave them her ingredients, her mixture, and then they produced it in mass. See, you see how I'm trying to be nice, and I do be trying to give people a little something. I be trying. But Duchess said inventing Anna / inventing Stormy, and I'm done. Thank you so much for the super sticker, Dana Marie. I appreciate you. You got me popping the trunk, because we going.
All right, we going. What a money reside.
But I really would like to see someone that is more neutral than me, for sure, more neutral than me, sit down with Stormy and have like a financial interview with her and ask her, like, why do you think that you keep overextending yourself, but you get these really good lucrative financial chances to not do that and try again? Why do you, like, what is it that has this hold on you that you have to, I don't know, but I need them to ask the questions. I need to be someone she feel comfortable with, because I honestly am very curious on this, because she was doing this even before she met Melody. Like, it just showed her true colors and a lot of other things, but this is how she's been. Because when she got that Apex loan, I think that was her first like new money downfall, because that should have went, and I'm sure that's what they thought it was going to be for, it should have went towards ramping up, scaling up, and I would have stayed in my modest house I was already in. I would have stayed in the modest vehicle I was in, and it would have been just purely to make sure I could fulfill those big box orders and my online orders, if I wasn't going to give up my online store, which for me, I would not give up my online store. I would not. That's what that money would have went to, because it was either 1 point something million or 2 point something million dollars. And if I would have treated myself, it would have been one thing if I treated myself like, let's celebrate your win. So I get that. But I wouldn't have done what she did, like the gold G-Wagon plus the plantation, all that stuff. Like, So I want somebody to sit down and talk about this. Like, for real, Trent, that's the problem. She too busy trying to outdo Mel. Mel ain't thinking about her. Once I saw her attitude and she got on the show, I couldn't support her anymore. Did you know about Angel? One, were you one of the people that knew about her before Love and Marriage Huntsville? Because I did admit that, oh, if you go back, she had a following, but you know, how can I put this? Quantitatively, she had a following and she had support. And I think she fumbled some things that she didn't have to fumble. That's how I put it. Stormy is the get rich quick. Another content creator showed how she changed one of the main ingredients on the original body glaze, and a lot of people complained. You are correct, Trendon. Thank you, Mama Capricorn. She's too busy trying to compete for really no reasons. As Mel says, there's enough money to be made for everyone, and quality is better than quantity. Quality is better than quantity, Kim Jones. I agree. I think she might have partnered with someone else, but not sharing that information. And that's fine. That's fine. Like, you know, if it's publicly available, we're going to figure it out anyway. But I understand if you're not trying to put it out there, that's fine. But it's the money management, and you need a professional too. At the scale that she was blessed with having, you do need a professional that is purely about monitoring the money and honestly advising you. They need to be dedicated to that, and then just sit in the wins until you're able to actually expand. But that's just me. Avia said, "Trending, do we have numbers for Charnita's World?" Okay, Avia, Melody actually had came in my live chat the other time, and that's when I was losing my brain, but I still remember to at least ask about that. And they may not Melody, but Nubia TV may not be releasing numbers. And it's a streaming platform, so to be fair, streaming platforms are usually not in the business of showing their numbers. I was just hoping we could see them, because I want to see the grassroots growth of this. But she did make a point to say that because of Charnita's World, Nubian TV had a significant bump in viewers because of that show. So that's what she gave us on that one. Thank you for asking that question, because I know a lot of people will have that question. Barbara, that actually happened already. I know that it's coming back out. And look, I'll be talking about some stuff that's already happened in the past, so I ain't saying like that. But I just want you to know, Apex already sued her, because that was the New York Supreme Court case. It was Apex. They already sued her. They won. Now they have a lien on her property because of that. You know what? If I was organized enough, we could take a quick Stormy tour. Hey, Chef Don Don, how you doing? You and your Don Dons. How are you? Pamela said, I never heard of her until the show, really. Okay, let me see what I have organized in my space, and I'll just show you the dates of this Apex stuff, because Yeah, they already got the lean. They already won. But I didn't get to see their complaint, but shout out to Pinky the housewife. I didn't get to see their complaint until recently because I didn't know which court they had sued her in. So that would be interesting just to see what their complaint filed was for. But they already won. They've been won. Let me see. Hold on. Let me see what I have. If y'all don't mind waiting on me just a second. I have to see if I really labeled anything correctly. And oh, snap. And redacted. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about for once. Okay, let me take this down. So I'll just show y'all the lien, aka second mortgage that Apex took out on her. 1 second here. Let's go into the courtroom. Let me take this down. I have to get so many. This is why I said Stormy ain't never, ever going to talk to me. But I don't really want to interview her because I kind of do like interviewing people I like. Like, it is kind of nice to do that. And I know if I ever want to grow beyond, like, be big, big, I'd probably have to get over that. But I don't know if that's my goal. So I'm okay with not being able to ever interview Stormy, I promise. Let me see. I'm trying to make it big so y'all can see it. All right. So here you go. This is the second mortgage they took out. This was recorded on June 16th, 2023. As you see, it says second mortgage, which I had to be taught because I don't know about second mortgages. Okay. I have a first mortgage and that's all I got. But second mortgages were told to me that that is a lien on the property. So that's why it's also called a lien. This mortgage is made this 8th day of June, 2023 between Stormy Shalicia Steele and Courtney Beasley. Collectively known as the mortgagers whose address is blank, and Apex Funding Source LLC, whose address is blank, New Jersey. And it says, whereas borrower is indebted to lender in the principal sum of $1,700,355.00, evidenced by inter alia, a settlement agreement. And it is at a 7.5% per annum from July 8th, 2022. So, if y'all do want to go over the Apex complaint on a different day, just like we got to go over Hinge, we got to go over the Hinge lawsuit. That's that dating app. We got to go over Mayor Tiffany Henyard's lawsuit that the church brought against her. But if y'all would still want to see it, although it did go in the past, let me know and we'll still review the complaint. But I just want to say shout out to Queen Black Titanic and Pinky the housewife, because Pinky may have already gone over this and I want to make sure that she gets credit that she did already go over it. But I would be more than happy to also, Mel's live. Hold on. I'll be more than happy to also go over it with y'all. Hold on, y'all. Hold on. I'm going. I see you, sis. I don't see her live. I'm refreshing. I don't see her. Did you just go to Instagram and it looked like she was live? Oh, TikTok. Y'all gonna kill me about TikTok. I have not logged on to TikTok on my desktop yet. So I can't get it yet, y'all. I'm sorry. Oh, you know what? Let me see if it'll show it to me while I'm not logged in. Some stuff, if you know what you're looking for, it'll show you. So I'll try to bring it up. Hold on. Danny said, run, right. Hold on. I'm trying to bring it up. Let me see. Ooh, Jesus Christ. Jesus. I hate when TikTok brings up random stuff. I'm so over it. Ew. Hold on, y'all. I'm looking. She don't stay live long on TikTok either. Look at this. Is she live? It says I have to log in. I can't get it, y'all. I can't get it. I'm a little down because I can't get it. Dang. Okay. I'll be watching my people to see if I can see it. I'm so upset right now. look, I'm over here being upset and still trying, in case you're wondering what I'm doing. I'm still trying. Oh, come on. It's a hater. Is this it? Hold on.
And she needs my face. She not y'all, and you can attest to this. Amazing, amazing, clean, clear foundation. You know what I'm saying? Like, I do believe in what I talk about, which is beauty on the inside. So, fortunately, like I said, what's that mom? Yeah. So, fortunately, I have like products that work that help me, because if not, I would probably be on some, like, breakouts all the time, because I'm not a big water drinker. I probably will be dry. You know how I like to say, the valley of dry bones.
Your skin is normal, so you get some oil.
I get some what?
It's normal. Yeah, you got normal skin.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, like, for real. Like, for real. So, I can take care of my skin. So, what we did this morning... we're at, okay, so let's get to 5K likes. So everybody hit the like button about 10 times. Go ahead and ask me, because I know y'all got some questions for me. So we're going to talk while we demonstrate. Tea Talk with your girl is on here. Hey, so I have my hydrating foam cleanser right here. We're going to talk while we demonstrate. Someone said sensitive skin. Yes, my products work great for sensitive skin too. I've had people DM me and like, Mel, I was nervous to try your products because I have such sensitive skin. But girl, it worked. So, yeah. Someone asked the question, how's work been going? See, I told y'all, y'all have some questions and we're going to get into it over here on the tick of the time, okay? So I'm going to come back to that question. But anyway, they were like, they have super sensitive skin and it has worked for them. They have not had any issues. Someone said the scrub has really helped with my eczema. So you guys know we have face scrubs and lip scrubs. Today I'm demonstrating the cleanser and the moisturizer, but we do have the scrubs too. I think that for me, you guys know, first my skincare was Embrace Beauty. Thank you for the shades, by the way. Oh, Crystal! But you know, take a picture with your shades on, because let me tell y'all, one thing about us over here, I'm going to keep it above. When we say we're going to do something, that's what we're going to do. If we say we're giving away some shades, y'all going to, we sending the shades. If we giving away some earrings, y'all going to get the earrings, whoever wins. If we say, what have we done? Wallet. We did Louis Wallet. We did Louis Gloves, scarves. We did some perfume. Mm-hmm. Baby, when we say, she said, when we say we're going to do something over here, we are going to do it. Tea Talk with your girl said, fat, standing on business. Did we get the 5K likes? Y'all questions about how work going to like to get to 5K. Actually, that's about a 10K like question for real. That's about a 10K like question. Everybody better hit about 20 times and I answer that question for y'all. About 20, 30, 40 times. Just oh, okay, wait a second. Yes, sorry. Girl, I'm sorry for a minute, babe. I thought I was somewhere else. We almost to 10K. We have 5,500. All right, everybody hit it about 20 more times. We're going to be there. Talk about work. Since y'all want to talk about work. Y'all want to talk about work while we do this demonstration. Culture vulture. So anyway, listen. Oh, thank you. That's cute. Ooh, that was cute. Girl, they had a cute little hat, blue little cowgirl hat up there on my head. While we talk, we all said, hey, girl, when I get them a number for the likes, they do not be playing. Y'all,
8K light. Okay, 2K more. We're going to talk about work. Boom. Follow me, cleanser. I'm going to put it on my face. Lauren just threw some foundation on my face for me so I can show y'all how I be working. Mm. Ooh. Well, we at 10K lights. All right, bet. Hey, Lauren. Okay. Give me that white towel right there. Yep. So, work. For me, work has been, let's see, where can I start? I feel like, and I'm assuming you're talking about show work, because you know I do a lot of stuff, but yes, the face wash is for sensitive skin. I'm assuming you're talking about show work. So for me, show-wise, this season, overall, I would say work has been kind of peaceful overall for me. Kind of peaceful for me. I have enjoyed knowing what it means and feels like to take my power back too. To the point where, you know, if I have something that let me tell you how I used to be. Let's go there. Tell you how I used to be. It used to be stressful for me to try to not let things down, specifically my baby, right? The show. And push and just make it happen. Just do it, you know. Push myself to the limit, so to speak. Not put myself first.
Yeah.
Right? Not put myself first. But it has been great taking my power back and being okay at times to say no, being okay to say I ain't available. When I need a mental health break, saying I need a mental health break for this week, I'm out, right? Like, just taking care of me. That's perfect.
Thank you.
Taking care of me. Lauren agreed. That's the thing. Taking care of me. Not worried about, because you know how it is, like, you don't want things to fall because you're not, you know, so you will sometimes just do stuff or push through because of that. But getting to a point where you just really trust God in a way where it's like, you know what? Whatever, come what may, you know, that's the perfect thing. Come what may, you know, but take care of you. That has been major for me. Like, the power of no, the power of unavailability, the power of taking care of my own mental health. Because let me tell you something. Nobody else is going to take care of your mental health like you. Nobody's going to care. No matter how much they say they're going to care. No, they don't. Ain't nobody going to care about your mental health. Nobody going to care about your emotional health like you. So getting to a place where I've been okay with taking charge of that and not caring about what comes because of that has been so freeing and empowering and just like, yes. Right? And then when I do it, I'm gonna be cute. I'm gonna have my hair all the way together. That makeup gonna be beat, thanks to Lauren. I'm gonna do my thing. But just realizing, because like I say, you can be in a place where you're kind of afraid to say, let's be real about it, right? You can be afraid. Whatever that was, a strawberry or something. I see she's sending some stuff. Let's get the 20K likes because we really getting into some stuff, actually. So y'all can hit that like button about 50 times, okay? Because we talking about some real stuff right now. And so let's be real. You can at times be afraid of consequences, you know, if you don't. But when you get to a point where you choose you over any consequence and you just be like, okay, come what may, but this is what I'm doing, this time moving, this is what it is. I think sometimes I care too much. If I can be real with y'all, there were times times I think where I just care too much. You know what I'm saying? Just and I literally had to get to a point where I'm like, no, you know what? I'm about to care about me too much. How about that? And, you know, not, we really didn't care about ourselves too much, but you get to play on the words. Now I'm about to care about me too much. So before we talk about this some more, we at 18K likes. Let's get to 30K. Everybody hit that like button about 30 times. Then we're going to talk about it some more. Go a little bit more deeper into it. Okay? We're at 19K. Okay, let's get to 30. Why are y'all liking and getting to 30? I'm gonna be over here doing my thing. So, here is how do you like it? How do I like what? You working out of thumbs. Hey, I love or that you working out of thumbs. Teresa sent a gift. Thank you. I'm tapping my phone so hard right now to get these likes up. Everybody gotta work together. Together, they'll be up. Everybody clicking like 50 times. We at 23K. We almost there. Click. I'm gonna do this. Phone cleanser. One thing I love about my products, y'all, it don't take a whole lot to do what needs to be done. Go ahead. Click. Click. Y'all at 26K, so y'all pretty much almost there. See, we about to get back into it. Oh, it smells. It's a smell for me. Baby, let me tell you something. If you go around somebody, honey, with my products on, you might as well just be ready, honey, because it's like, you can't help it. They can't help it either. Okay, so Laura said that down. I knew she was gonna have something. See? Cleanser. So Laura said they better. You get on my nerves, y'all. They ain't gonna be able to control themselves, help themselves, none of that. See that? Yeah, y'all see it. And I did this on purpose. I want y'all to see it. Now I'm going to go to another part of the towel and wipe it again. Now, let's talk about it. We've all been in positions where we don't want to do anything to upset, you know, to cause issues at your work, you know. So you try to play it safe. But sometimes playing it safe gets thrown out the window. Right here, wiping off this makeup. What I use for y'all just coming on is my hydrating foaming cleanser. Okay. Here's number two. So you see, got better. And now I'm gonna go to a third spot. But so I literally got to a place where I was like, you know what? I don't want to say I don't care because I care, but I care about me more than anything. And you know what I said? This is the third one. I'm totally done. I'm going to show y'all. Here was number one. Here was number two. And look, y'all see these are just quick little gentle wipes. My makeup is pretty much this is going to be the last one right here. This is it starting. I got to the point where I was like, you know what, honey? Ooh, boom. See that? Because I use my cleanser, hydrating facial cleanser. It smells, it smells great. It's so gentle. My skin feels so soft and smooth, and it smells great. So what I did, one of the things I did, is I took a mental health break for a week. And now I'm coming over here with moisturizer. No, you cannot go on my line. Decline. Sorry, sir. My moisturizer. So I took like a mental health week off from work. I don't think I've ever done that. I've been working since I was like 13. So ever since I did my aunt was VP at a company in Birmingham. I used to go to Birmingham every time and work with her starting when I was 13. So I've been working for a long time. My mom had a cleaning company. I would work with my mom. I worked at the bank for 3 years. I worked at Subway, all this high school stuff. Bank, Subway, cleaning company. I've always worked hard. So for me, when I make a commitment to do something or to be a part of something, I don't like to take days off for real. I don't like to, I like to show up. Every time you need me, I'm the person like, I want to be able to be there. I want to be able to be there. I don't like to let people down, you know? And so what has been so empowering for me this time is like, I took a mental health break week. Like that was big for me. That was so, I was so proud of myself. I was so proud of myself. I literally took a mental health week. And when I tell y'all, you know what? I'm going to tell y'all. I'm going to let Lauren tell y'all. Lauren, come here, Lauren. Mm-hmm. Well, I put the moisturizer on. My skin looks so pretty. And it smells, my skin, it smells good, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. You know Lauren, mm-hmm. I'm doing my moisturizer now, y'all. Tell them how you feel. What happened or how did I change or what difference did you see after me just pausing everything for a week and taking a mental health break?
So I wasn't here that week, but I was talking with you and you just seemed more refreshed. You just, like you said, you just took control back.
Mm-hmm. I don't see you.
No, she just took control back over mm-hmm. the situation. I feel like she came back and she had that time to spend time with the kids yeah. and, you know, just really enjoyed that week off.
Mm-hmm. My friends.
Phone was off, email. You weren't really doing anything mm-hmm. that week.
No.
Yeah. And so I feel like you needed that.
No.
I feel mm-hmm. like you came back to work refreshed, rejuvenated. Like, okay, let's be, like you said, showing up to scenes, looking cute,
yeah.
giving them what they needed.
Yeah.
But I think it was very much needed. And I'm glad you did take that break. Because, yeah. like you said, we sometimes do become afraid of not showing up.
Yeah.
Because we feel like what's the consequence of not being
That's
there.
It. That part. When you get to the point where you say, no. whatever you say, baby, it is what it is, baby. Okay.
You have to learn how to say no.
To say no.
You uh-huh. don't want to put yourself in a situation where it's like, oh, okay, whoa, like you scared to step. It's like, no, let me step back.
Let me step back. Yeah, yeah, and that's what it was. Like, step back. And I tell people sometimes I'm just adding a little more moisturizer just because, but I really did enough. It feels so good though. Like it's kind of cool. It just feels good. I'm sorry, so forgive me, but I love it. It's so great. Sometimes, and I've said this before, it's almost like you are saving people from you.
Yeah.
You for me. So you better take a break.
But if you know where you can go.
Talk more about that if we get to 50K. We had 40. Everybody had like done about 50 times. We're gonna get to 40,000. Oh, we had 40. I mean we're gonna get to 50,000. Y'all coming on while y'all hitting the like button. I'm gonna show them again. Oh, I got some of the makeup right here. I'm gonna show them again. We have been using the foaming facial cleanser. Right now, you can get all of these products off for 30% using the code Los Angeles over on my website. Or you can buy it on TikTok Shop. Totally up to you. Doesn't matter to me. But Los Angeles does give you 30% off if you want to try my foaming cleanser or if you want to try my Vitamin Boost Moisturizer. Okay? That's what we've used today. We're at 44K. Y'all hit it about 50 times. We're going to talk about that some more where we just left off. Okay? Because, yeah, we talking about saving people from you. We at 45K, hit it by 50 times. We got 200 people pretty much on here. Let's go. Saving people from you. Okay? Let's talk about it. That's neat. Let me see what it says. Oh, okay. Yeah. Y'all hold on a second. Okay. That's what I was saying. Boom. Boom. Oh, I can't do that right now. Okay. We may do it in a little bit. Okay, we're at 50,000. So, one of the most beautiful things I feel is when you learn yourself, mm-hmm. right? And you learn yourself in a way to where you know what your triggers are, right? You know where you can go, and you know what can calm you down. You got to take time to learn yourself that way. And I'll be honest with you. I've shared this many a time. That's you. I've shared this many a time before. I'm going to share it now. I've spent more time alone the past like 2-3 years than I have my whole life. But spending time by myself has allowed me to learn myself, has allowed me to sit with me, right? Allow me to get to know who is this girl at 38, at 37, 36. Like spending these few years being more alone than I've ever been has helped me to learn me. So if you are, if you always, you know, don't ever spend time with you, how are you going to learn you? Because you're like, when there are other people around all the time, you kind of feeding off of them. Y'all feeding off each other. But it's something about when you can sit there with yourself. This is what we did today, y'all. Sit with yourself and literally learn more about yourself. That's where it is. So I know my triggers. I know where I can go. And I don't want to do that. So when I need to take a break, and that's okay. It's nothing to be, don't fear. Because the one thing I know, whatever it is that God has for you, you're going to have it. And that's what people mess up sometimes too. But let me tell you something. God is your source, not man. I know I have me a lip primer over here now. Open already. Not man. Here's my lip primer too. If you've been using chapstick, if you use this, you're going to never go back to chapstick. I'm going to tell you that right now. Not man. Not no job, not no employer, not no boss, none of that. God is your source, period. It don't matter, because let me tell you something. If there's somewhere in life that God wants you to be, you can get fired today. And you know what? You're going to still be where he wants you to be when he wants you to be there tomorrow, next week, or the month after that. You know? God's your source. We give too much power to humans. You know, we give too much power to them. Nuh-uh. And that's why I said I've been feeling real empowered lately. Quit laughing, Lauren. Y'all, Lauren laughing. Don't pay Lauren on mine. This right here is my lip primer. Let me show you guys. 7th Avenue. Yeah. Can y'all see it well? 7th Avenue lip primer. 30% off if you use the code Los Angeles. Yeah, God is your source. Okay, period. And I'm going to show y'all the lip primer again. What's another question y'all got that we just y'all want to talk about? Here's this. This is the moisturizer. Somebody said love the trending. Said love the lip primer. Thank you, trending. I'm going to get this moisturizer and just put it on my hand just to show you guys. Little bit goes a long way, and everything smells so fresh and so clean. Okay, so fresh and so clean. Mrs. King, DM me, honey, so I can check on your stuff for you. Smells so fresh and so clean. Oh my gosh. So, and just a little bit goes a long way. And listen, if you get your product and you were like, where's the seal? Look under your cap. Sometimes the seals just twist off with the cap. Okay. Have they tried to talk to you about the melometers during filming? So I feel, you know, I feel stuff before it airs. Okay. I cannot do that. What I will say to you is, anytime anybody tries to come to me on some melometers this, the melometers that, I don't care who it is, baby, they gonna get it every single time. I'm gonna remind you where they came from, why, what role you played in why they came out and said, oh, no, I know you lying. I'm going to remind you of all of that. Then I'm going to remind you or make you aware of who in your life, who you know personally that you can't seem to control talking about me. So don't ask me to control nothing. You know, because you got people that you know that you could call at any moment and say, man, back down off a meal. Like, chill out. No. So anyway, honey, I'm not doing no melometer. Slander, what's up? We at 64k likes. Let's get to 80 real quick. 80k likes. Everybody hit the like button probably 50 times and then we'll be there. We're gonna talk about millimeters some more. Because I see all the chess pieces in the chat. What do you have to say? You know you that when you call all this conversation. Woo! That's what I got to say about the melometers. You know y'all that when you cause all this conversation. That's all I got to say about it. That's all I got to say about it. But let me tell y'all something. There will be no dismantling of any fan base over around here. It's not going to happen. There will be no dismantling. There will be no, you know, I mean, the fact of the matter is, everybody who do stuff, this will be getting me, are not melometers. I don't know why. Every time something happened, people just wear the melometers. Like, sometimes y'all be giving the melometers too much credit. Let's just keep it above. Y'all be giving the melometers too much credit sometimes, baby, because just because it's going against your faith don't mean the melometers behind it. To be honest with you, a lot of them got too much to be doing than to be doing all of that. Sometimes just people don't like you. Like, somebody don't like you. Like, come on now. So I'm not the one. I'm saying y'all this. So we at 80k yet? So when we get to 80k, I'll say what I was about to say. Y'all at 72. Go ahead and hit the 80. Then y'all know we're gonna hit 100. We're gonna make it do what it do. If you're just coming in, what we've been doing today is using the foaming, hydrating foaming cleanser. We have also used my amazing vitamin booster moisturizer. Give your skin everything that it needs right here. And then I ended it out with my lip primer. 5 more K, we'll be at 80. Y'all hit it about 10, 15 times. We'll be there. Let me show you guys. I literally did my cleanser, just one run on my face, put it on there. I wiped it here, then I wiped it here, then I went on the other side, then I wiped it here, and then I wiped it here. Where's the fourth? Right. There was 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Oh, well, that's the fourth one right here. Okay. So we did all that today. So, because I wanted y'all to see, like, just how easily the makeup comes off. And we're there. So I'm not 1, 2, 3, nor 4. Okay. When it comes to trying to talk about the melometers, I'm sorry. Shut up. Shut up. I'm just going to keep it above. Shut up. You know, like, stop. And period. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope. You know, like, uh-uh. Sorry. At some point, people have to be accountable for their actions, the way they do things, the way they handle things, the way they handle people, the way, and that don't mean everything is about the melodies. That's just how I feel about it. Wish everybody the best. May you do well in whatever you're doing. But we're not about to make everything know all the millimeters. No, that's not what we're about to do. Stop it. See, sometimes people hate the way people love you. Let's talk about it for a minute. Sometimes people hate the way people love you. Okay? And so what they will do is they will try to come in between the way people love you because they think, oh, if I can remove her support, then she gonna, and I'm just talking about people, period. It could be a man say, oh, she gonna come back to me. If I isolate her from her friends, if I isolate her from her family, she gonna come back to me. How can I put a wrench up in what she got going on with the people who love on her and support her? Because then she probably gonna come back to me. Move people who support her because then she probably do what I want her to do. Let's just be honest. That's how people be thinking. That's how people think. And if you for 1 minute think that I'm that weak, that would cause that, then you don't know me at all. Let me just be honest. You don't know me at all. Because one thing male can do is male can move. I move solo. And no one to have no whole 15, 20 best friends. Never have been. I grew up as an only child. So I know how to move solo. I know how to go in my room and play by myself. God knew I needed that experience. You ready for this point of my life? But I'm just saying, I'm going to entertain myself, play by myself, make decisions on my own. I've never been a follower. I've always been a motherfucking leader. Period. Always have been. Always been a leader. Always have been. Here's the thing, the cleanser. Pretty. You missed it, Lauren. What I knew, I didn't say the blame. Lauren tried to charge me $5 for cussing, and I didn't even cuss. What I knew? Whatever, Lauren. Anyway, here's the hygienic thing, a foaming cleanser. Here's the face moisturizer that we use today. Girl, I think I'm saying something about make sure I'm showing the products. You showing talk about TikTok live violation. Make sure you showing the products. I've been showing the products, so let me show them again for TikTok. Okay, here we go. A little problem. But like I was saying, if you think that, then you don't know me at all. Because I'm more of a solo mover than anything. Now I can help that I've garnered love and support because people love my authenticity and people love that. You know, what I give and who I am, and they see, you know, my soul. I can't help that. That's what it is. So, not am day of the week, am I a follower? Not am day of the week, am I afraid of any demons? Not am day of the week, am I ever afraid to go to war with any demons? Not no day of the week. None. I understand what spiritual warfare looks like, and because of that, let's go. I'm like, hey, you know, it's very evident. Oh, Lauren, see, I be using the mama oil that Lauren mama had prayed over this oil right here and gave it to me. I told her, I ain't never seen no blessed oil in a Tiffany and Company bag. That's how I know they bougie. Y'all know it, too. Y'all know it's the truth. Y'all have never seen no holy blessed oil, baby. No crate over oil in no Tiffany bag. When Lauren brought this to me from her mother, I anointed the door at the reunion. Remember? Oh no, more KB at Come on, y'all. Click that like button like 15, 20 times. Listen, they say add it to the show.
Yes.
No, we will not be selling the anointing. They said the bougie anointing oil. Yes. In a 10 minute
when I'm watching. Oh, that's the
bougie. Bless the bougie. Listen, okay. They said, come on, Lord Mother, bless. Bless the mouth. Bless the bougie. What else we got? Bless the bold, because I'm bold everything that I do and say. What else?
That's the behavior.
Don't like. Y'all come get this little girl. Come get this little girl over here. Listen, come get Lauren. They said, y'all so messy. Y'all so messy. They said, not Optimus and Lauren. See the cleanser? It's time to be whenever the person who won your bid and come and get you.
There we go.
And that's what the thing is gonna do. Give up. Yeah. One thing that I know, let me just keep it above. Sometimes the devil will make you look like you're winning, make you think you're winning. That's what he's supposed to do, because that causes you not to look at your actions to think you're doing anything wrong. But that only lasts for a short amount of time. That is very short-lived. Let me keep it above. The longevity and the blessings is where it's at. That's when you know the sustainability in the blessings is where it's at. So you pay attention to the sustainability. You got to look fine. Mm-hmm. Yeah, TikTok ain't going to tell me I'm violating them. The sustainability of the blessings is how you know. The continuity of the blessings is how you know. See, the enemy will trick you and make you think that you're doing right, but it's a short-lived time. And all he's doing is taking you out there to that water, baby. Taking you on over there, on over there, on over there to that water. And he's going to leave your ass. I'm sorry. He's going to leave you out there so you can drown. I didn't want to pay $5, so I stopped myself. I don't even have me paying $5. Leaving you out there so you can drown. That's just the truth. That's just the truth. That's what the devil does. The devil's gonna take you on out there to that water, baby, have you out in the big blue ocean in the middle of the sea, and then gonna leave you out there, okay? So you can drown by yourself. And he's gonna go ahead and find another car to do all that he needs done that's evil. inserting moisturizer here. The moisturizer's here. I can only pin one thing at a time. The moisturizer, y'all know I'm still learning, but I know I can only pin one thing at a time. Let me see. Yeah, the moisturizer is in there too. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's just what I'm saying. Okay. But you got to look at, if you pay attention, you'll see. And you know what's so interesting? Because Lauren be here with me a lot of times. You know, the funny thing is that I really don't be bothering nobody. That's the funny thing. It's literally a situation to where people just be coming out the woodworks. I don't be thinking about them demons. I don't be talking about them demons. I don't be checking for them demons. I be working. When I ain't working, I'm catching up on my rest, doing my children. But most of the time, I'm working. Like, and that's how you know. Because it's like, when something, I always tell people, when something does not make sense in the natural, because the natural tells me, why do you believe? But when it don't make sense in the natural, you got to go look at that spiritual, because that's what it is. It's spiritual. Things happening in the spiritual aren't going to make sense in the natural. And things that happen in the spiritual ain't going to make sense. I mean, in the natural ain't going to make sense in the spiritual. It's just how it is. How many? We got 105. So, yeah, when it don't make sense in the natural, like, let's say you're trying to get another job and you know you qualify and you've been applying and applying and applying. You're like, oh, but what I'm getting this job, because it don't make sense. I know I'm more than qualified to have this job. Baby, in the spiritual, there could be God, something that God is keeping you from that you don't even see. He also could be trying to grow your faith spiritually, you know, that spirit piece of you. So anytime it doesn't make sense in the natural, don't beat yourself up. Don't spend a lot of time trying to figure it out, because I definitely don't. Don't spend a lot of time trying to figure it out. Just accept it for what it is. Accept it for what it is. It's spiritual. And keep it moving. And keep it moving. Because that's what we do. Like, and keep it moving. That's cute. Y'all say understood, yes. All right, so before we get ready to go, I'm gonna show y'all one more thing in case y'all don't know. Y'all know I've been showing y'all my lemon face scrub too this week. So before I go, just because I'm gonna pull some out, show y'all the lemon. I've been showing y'all how you can use it as a mask, showing you guys the consistency. It smells delicious, but don't eat it. Don't you dare say I told you to eat it. So I've been showing y'all this lemon. My lemon face scrub. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Spiritual warfare. You can't fight spiritual with karma. Oh, this is good. Oh, this smells so good. That, my lemon stuff smells so good. Oh, that shit was cute. Why go away so fast? Thank y'all. It does smell like something to eat. Listen, I'm telling you. And y'all can get all of these products right now on my site, 7thAvenueBeauty.net, 30% off. And literally, like, use code Los Angeles to get 30% off your order. Ooh, woo. And so remember, let me wet it a little bit. I used my sponge, my exfoliating sponge, right, and showed you guys. And it's still gentle. Remember, I told y'all you don't want to rub off the healthy skin, so you shouldn't be doing anything that's too hard. Soften it up with the water. Exfoliating. See? So, how's my wrist been feeling? Oh my gosh. So, let me tell y'all this. Oh, this may help some people. Oh, this smells so good. If I had a boo, it'd be like, girl, come here, girl. Let me kiss your hand. Let me kiss on your hand, girl. Let me just kiss on your hand. Okay, but anyway, so. Shut up, Lauren. Y'all get your friend. My wrist. So this thing, my wrist has been feeling great. There's this thing called, well, let me share a few things. There's this thing called red laser therapy. And I have been doing red laser therapy with my chiropractor. So what they do is they get this little wand and they rub it. Lauren said, yes, right. They rub it over, they hurt too long. They rub it over your wrist. You can do your back as well. I've done my back. When my back was hurting, I did my back. I've done my wrist. But what it goes in, it gets the collagen, it goes in and gets the collagen going. It also breaks down so it can rebuild, goes into your cells. So my wrist feels great. And then also, you know, I've been working out. So I have also been strengthening my wrist that way. See, people don't want to talk about how if you aren't making your muscles stronger, they're get weak. If you're not doing weight training, keeping your legs strong, keeping your arm muscles, your shoulders, everything strong, they're going to get weak. And then when, as you get older, that's when you're going to be having shoulder replacements, knee replacements, any other thing that need to be replaced that you can replace. So my wrist has also been better because I've been working out. So I'm lifting weights. I'm doing all this stuff. So it's strengthening it too. But red laser therapy is the bomb, like for real. Like, if you can find someone in your area who does red laser therapy, I would say go for it because it does work. When my back was hurting me, y'all, and I could barely even bend over, I went in there, baby, they got that one on me a couple of times, like about two sessions, I was back to normal. So, if you can find someone who does that where you live, do it. Do it. Okay, do it because it does work. Okay, but anyway, I enjoyed y'all today. Had a great time. Make sure you guys go get your cleanser, your lip primer, get your moisturizer as well. And if you want to get your lemon bundle or lemon drop face scrub, do that as well because you know all of them work natural, paraben free. Y'all know we have a beautiful black chemist who I work with who's out of Dallas, Texas, who makes our products. We work together to make sure we're giving you guys things that actually work. So, yeah, but I love you guys. Enjoyed y'all today. And I'll probably come on here tomorrow and we'll have some more fun and talk about some more juicy stuff.
Okay, I had to unmute myself and get everything back. Oh my gosh, y'all. So we got to keep an eye out for tomorrow. I don't even know how I'm going to do this. I know I'm supposed to be reviewing Charnita's World tomorrow and stuff. Oh my gosh, so much just happened. You need to go back and replay if you didn't catch everything that Melody said on this particular live because she said a lot. I will definitely cut out when she started answering questions about the show and the Melometers and everything. Alf MC, I got you, sis. I got you. Wow. Let me see. Did she schedule one? Let me see if she already, did she schedule another one? No. Okay. But I know how to look. So I'm going to start trying to look. You are so welcome. Thank y'all for alerting me. I'm glad I really kept trying because this is one of those ones you didn't want to miss. Oh my gosh. What God has for you is always for you. Right. So true, Pamela. Yes. The strawberry. Oh, and I saw in her story. So let's go to her stories because as Thethi, I think, put in there, she said she can't wait for that blueberry scrub. So let me go to Melody's stories real fast. Hold on. Let's see here. Because we got a few things. Okay. Oh my goodness. It was so much. That is hilarious. Whoever put Blessed and Bougie in the TikTok live chat, y'all funny. And you know it's going to stick now. Blessed and Bougie. Yes, that's what it is. That's what it is. Let me see here. Okay. Hold on. Yep, apple, cinnamon, and pumpkin spice on sale so they can get ready for the new scent. And I remember she said berries, so one of them, because she'll probably do more than one. Come on, blueberries. Yes, let's go. And then she showed it here, the bottom of the, look, yep. Look, y'all. Blueberries. Jess, you said blessed and you did say blessed and bougie. You put it in the TikTok chat too? Were you in the TikTok chat? Because I know some of y'all said, Trina, I got to move you because I had to get on TikTok. Thank you for still staying, just moving me to a different device. Oh, orange burst. So blueberry, orange, and orange burst. Come on. Oh, snap. I knew it was going to be more than one. Love that she touched on people's comments in a boss way. Right, Miss Cutie Pie. Alpha MC said, thanks so much, training. I think clipping out that section of Melody's live is going to be epic. Wow. Thank you for being here. And yes, I will do it as soon as this video. I only actually have to wait for it to process. I think I can start cutting it from StreamYard. Go ahead and let it process and get it up. But yes, I agree, Alpha MC. It was this account. Oh, this account that said blessed and bougie. Now watching you from both. Hey, okay. Hey, Terry T, baby. Blueberry smells so good. I can't wait. Robin, what do you mean? What did you miss? Robin. Okay, Robin, maybe you were here for most of it, I thought. But Melody just had a whole live on TikTok. She was going in about people trying to come for the Melometers. Oh, and then I had put in a question. I said, did they try to ask you or talk to you about the Melometers during filming? She was like, you know, I can't say nothing about things that haven't aired yet, but let me tell you this. And then she went in. She went in, Robin. And then Duchess said she was the one that said blessed and bougie in the TikTok chat. That's Duchess. Crown Source Jewelry is also Duchess. Got it. Got it. You know, you're going to have to remind me again, but I got it right now. I don't have a TikTok account. This TikTok video needs to go viral. The haters are going to come out of the woodworks. She kept it straight to the point in the Melody way. I love it. Me too, Mama Capricorn. Yeah, please. Now, y'all, I do not say this every time I'm on, but there are some videos I need you to please share. Please. And while we're on the subject of Melody and just people in her, you know, atmosphere, Jay Taylor, y'all know Jay Taylor is one of her friends. Let me get this going. Hold on, y'all. Y'all got to stick around because Chef Don Don just gave me this and I want to make sure y'all see it. So don't go nowhere so I can show you this. Hold on. Let me start getting it together. It won't take too long because I think it's already in my Google Drive. I just got to get it on. I swear to God, don't play me. Do not play me. I know I said, oh, there it goes. Woo! Look, I'm about to get mad at my own self. Okay, hold on. Here it comes. This is the announcement. So we got blueberry. Let me see if I got anything else. I want to make sure y'all saw. Oh, here's the testimonies, Mama Capricorn. You were like, does Melody ever post testimonies? It's a few of them. When your friend texted you this on a Friday, she said, hey, I meant to tell you that I've been using your leave-in and oil every week when I do my hair. I really like it. It leaves my hair super soft. Even when I got my hair done the other day, or it might have been Cece. It was Cece or Mama Capricorn, sorry. The girl asked what I'd been using because it felt so good. And then, hold on. This one said, your product is the GOAT. My feet look and feel like baby skin after 1 month of use. So there you go. There you go. I know that's a Queen Sheba subscriber. I see. I recognize that icon. Mama Capricorn, I ain't going nowhere. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, I'm bringing it up. It's coming. It's coming. Y'all, thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for alerting me that she was live. I really, really appreciate it. I can't always do it every time, but I definitely at least want to know to see if I can, you know, if it is something I can do. Here we go. Bam. Let me take off. Hold on. Let me take this off. Jay Taylor, Chef Don Don, Saturday Night Giggles, streaming only on YouTube. Let me get my banner down. Saturday, March 16th, 2024, 9:45 p.m. Central Standard or Eastern Standard Time, 8:45 p.m. Central Standard Time. Come through and support Jay Taylor and Chef Don Don. It did, Rashida. It's blueberry. She got a blueberry and an orange. It did come out. We just looked at her stories. I was just showing it in the jar. So I don't know if it's in the store yet. It might be, but I just want she did announce the flavors today. I said flavors, but you know, the scents. She announced them today. Miss Cutie Pie said, oh, can't wait. Barbara said, hey, everyone, I'm driving, but I heard my friend name. Uh-oh, Barbara, he got to get in his tub. Jay Taylor and Chef Don Don have their show time, date. I'm so excited. So hold on now. Okay, so I'm going to miss the beginning. Hold on, no, it's 8:45. I'm going to miss the beginning because we're going to be watching Charnita. Why do you keep trying to keep my old lady up? I be trying to be asleep. Hey, Cinnamon Swirl. April said, oh, this is about to be a good time and laugh. It is. And they're streaming on YouTube. So, okay, for those of us that sometimes might have to be replay gang gang because we tired, I'm ready. I want to be there live. I want to be there live so bad. Yes, Alf, they have done it. They're doing a collab. Alf, they're also going to cook together at least once. So I'm not saying that's what they're going to do this Saturday, but just so you know, Chef Don Don said he and Jay will be cooking together as well. Joe said, I'm going to be front and center. Come on, Jay and Chef. Yes, yes. Let me see if Chef Don Don has time to come talk about it now that he officially announced it. Hold on. Let me see. Okay, I'm going to have to put my mic on mute, but I'm here. Don't go nowhere. All right, I'm over here. I will be trying to get on people's nerves. So hopefully while I'm still live, he'll answer me because I'm trying to see if he'll come talk about it now that he said more or, we got this. Pamela said, indeed. Hey, Golden Life. They are hilarious together. I will have my drink ready. Yes. Yes, Miss Cutie Pie. First Last, I'm watching replay on TV, Trendies and Minds. Oh, thank you, First Last. Yeah, I had went on mute. I went on mute to try to see if I could. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. He said he can. Okay. All right. Yes. Perfect. Let me go ahead and start getting the link ready to drop. So when he comes in, he'll already have it. He said, oh, you were paused. So that's for Chef Don Don, y'all. If he comes back in, he said he can. So hopefully. He's coming in. That's for him. Let me see. The only other thing I'll share after Chef Don Don, because I can't leave out the artist that I had put on the thumbnail. We got to talk about her, but we'll do it after Chef Don Don if he's coming up now, because he said he could. So hopefully he knows that means now. I pray everything goes well for them in their collaboration. Those haters had better stay away. You know, anybody connected to Melody draws attention. Yes. And the thing is, too, though, it usually goes well for those that are genuinely connected to Melody. It goes well for those that be trying to hide their real ways. It don't go so well. So they should be just fine. Y'all, we need to have the wine or cocktails we watch. Right. So, okay. So for those of us, some of us are going to come in while they already in because Charnita's world is 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 8 to 9 Central Standard Time. We're going to be, oh, there we go. We got Chef Don Don. Here we go. Hey, Chef.
Hey, what's going on? What's
up? How are you?
Oh, you know, just a little busy on this Friday, but I'm good. How are you?
Chef, I'm so good. I'm so excited for you and Jay.
Listen, y'all just don't know what y'all in store for. Okay. Yeah. I want to say that.
Okay.
This is something that we're going to be doing for, it ain't just going to be a one-time thing. Like, we're going to continue to keep doing it, show some consistency. I'm super excited.
Oh, it went out when you said I'm super excited. Are you still there?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah, it stopped at I'm super excited. That's the last I heard.
Oh, sorry. Okay, no, I was saying I'm super excited because we're going to continue to do this. So it won't just be a one-time thing. It'll be something that we will continue to do.
Oh, good. Hey, look, this is me. Mama Capricorn had to correct me. I'm so silly. Y'all right. You right, Mama Capricorn. Charnita is today, and they are tomorrow. Thank you for getting me together.
Remember, we were going to do... we were going to do Fridays, but I'm getting ready to start shooting another project, and so I won't have time on Fridays.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Yes, so. I'm excited, Chef. What can you tell us that we can expect for tomorrow? What can we expect for tomorrow?
Okay. I'm pretty sure y'all have been wanting to know. Okay, this is an exclusive. Oh, this is an exclusive. I might get in trouble for actually saying this too, but okay, whatever. I'll take it. So we are going to discuss because I'm sure y'all want to know what we feel about the Charnita in Heavenly situation. Mm-hmm. That's a teaser. Okay. So we'll discuss that. We will be discussing Charnita's world as well. Okay, so I'll just say this. Let's just say it'll be a hot topic type of giggles type of situation for tomorrow. So but that's not how the show is going to continue to go. So I'll say that.
Gotcha. Okay. Okay.
And we ain't cooking just yet, but it will be soon. I promise y'all it'll be soon. I promise y'all. The cooking is coming.
Hey. I can't wait. I can't wait to hear Jay's thoughts on Charnita and Heavenly. I know some of yours, but I can't wait to see y'all together talk about it, because new things come out when you talk to someone outside of yourself about a topic. You know, so yeah. I can't wait to hear your thoughts on that as well.
And you know what? Actually, I haven't really given any thoughts on Heavenly and Charnita, honestly. I think I've given thoughts on Heavenly outside of that, but
probably
not specifically that. And I honestly had to catch up. Was that yesterday or the day before on what actually really happened? Because I can see everybody talking about it. I'm like, Lord, what Heavenly done said? Now, child, my God. But I agree with the minority. I do. I agree with the minority on that one.
Now, when you say the minority, what is the minority thought?
Well, how everybody feels about...
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, gotcha. That's what I meant by that. Sorry. but pretty much how everybody feels about it. Like, I felt like, you know, Heavenly was absolutely wrong. In that, just absolutely all the way wrong. Will we be discussing Carlos? So you gotta keep in mind, Jay also has to be, you know, careful because
he
is still, you know, working for
people.
So he has to be extremely careful on some of the topics and some of the things that we discuss. So I want y'all to go into it understanding that, okay, that some things we may not be able to tap into.
Right. Fully. Oh, understood.
I mean, it's going to be fun. I promise you guys are going to have a good time. Come with your popcorn. Come with your giggle box. And just have a good time with us. And again, we'll be doing this every Saturday. It'll be on YouTube. I think you can catch it on both of our YouTubes, but if not, y'all know that I can catch it on mine for sure.
Right. I was just about to ask if y'all are going to co-stream. Okay, yeah, because we know we'll just have both of y'all playing.
Well, you know, he don't know nothing about what he doing over there. So trying to set this up.
That's true, because he'd be like, how I turn this live off? This live.
He didn't even know how to work Instagram live, so you know he don't know how to use StreamYard. So it is going to be a key, but we'll try to get it to air on both platforms to help grow his platform as well. But okay. I'm excited. I think you guys are going to enjoy it, and it will always be late nights on Saturdays.
I'm so glad it's going to be a regular thing, Chef Donna, not a one-off. We have missed y'all since y'all's last get together. Like, we need this.
You know, I have received so many DMs. Chef, it's March. You said y'all was doing something in January.
Yeah.
Like, okay, girl, I get it. We're trying. Well, we really did have to match schedules.
I was like, hey, I'll see it.
Everybody had been saying that. I was like, listen, child, we coming. I promise we coming. But I definitely can't wait for y'all to see once we are in the same room. I cannot
right.
wait for
and
that.
Y'all will be live, right? This will be live.
Yes, this will be okay. live. This will be okay. live. Yes, yes. That's yes. the unique part about it. It will be live.
Absolutely. Nice. Okay, I can't wait for him to like basically Jones on you because that's really what he be doing.
Can he do it all the time? I'm so used to it. I just laugh it off, honey. Yes. I just laugh it off. And if I have something I want to say, I say it. And you know that.
Y'all been friends.
Jay and I have been friends for 3 years now. Three.
Okay.
Yeah, 3 years now. So yeah. And the funny thing is like I guess when you meet people, you truly understand, you know.
Yeah. They're sorry, I don't want to interrupt you. I don't want to be that doctor on Charnita's World. They're gonna get me. Go ahead.
Wait, Charnita's World? What happened? What we do
Wait,
now?
What were you gonna say about Jay when you truly meet somebody? You say that, then I'll say what I had to say.
Oh Lord, what I done now? Okay, no, it's I me. Was saying, no, I was just saying that I feel like we just truly have a really, really genuine friendship. So yeah, I'm here for
gotcha.
It.
I was about to make a joke. And because everybody was talking about the doctor that was in the marriage counseling with Charnita and her husband kept cutting them off. And I said, oh, I don't want to be that doctor because I didn't want to cut you off while you were still talking.
That doctor was kind of irritating me a little bit. I'm like, can you stop doing that? But yes, I can't wait either. Come on, Teresa, right? Teresa said she made them stuffed shrimp, baby. Come on,
I love that. I love when our people like be the like you know the Don Dons are the trendies. The trendies are the Don Dons. Like I mean, I love stuff like that. Like
that literally is the case. Like the Don Dons be on it. The trendies do too, honey. They be on it. Okay, I'm ready to laugh. Yes, y'all. I promise we're gonna have a good time. We are gonna kiki, and you never know who may stop by.
Oh, that's a good. Oh my God. Oh my God. You're right. We never know.
You never know who may stop by and grace us with their.
So prayer. Basically, I ain't gonna get no sleep. That's what I'm hearing. Just don't even plan on
sleep. Hey, you just never know. You just never ever know. You know.
I'm about to figure out how to work y'all into like a little mini recap too. You know.
That would be fun. That would be fun. Yeah, listen, we're just really here. We just want to have a good time. We really do.
And y'all bring some laughter and joy. Y'all was fun and natural. Like I'm so happy I ran across y'all. Of course, my first reason I ran across your channel was because anything when it said Melody's makeup artist, I was like, uh-oh, what happened? And then to see that it was so refreshing, I'm so glad I saw that. Did you go mute? Are you talking?
Can you hear me?
Now I can.
Oh, you can. You can. Okay. No, I was just gonna say, that is when we met you was after the first interview.
Maybe the second.
I mean, the second. Yeah. It was the second one. Yeah, it was the second one. It was the second one. Chef Jay and Scotty would be a key. Oh God, child, that child. I'm a little nervous about the other people. That's all I got to say. I'm just a little nervous.
Because
y'all know Jay just has no filter.
Sometimes. Oh, so like if y'all start co-mingling with somebody outside of y'all's dynamic?
Yeah, like. You know how it can get sometimes.
Yes, I get it now. Y'all gonna be okay though. We gonna hope everything will go fine, and they'll just, you know, I feel like if you get them, you get them. So like, hopefully everything will just be okay. But I get you. I do. I have some dynamics like that. Like, what? Hold on now. Like, this is good when it's us.
Yeah, like not too many people now. Cause listen. If you call me a stingy friend, call me
I like that. I think I'm a stingy friend too.
I am now. There are certain people now. Other folks, I don't really care about. But there are like literally three people in my life that I can't be as little stingy with. I most definitely. Jay is one of them. I will say that.
Yeah, I could see that. I gotta tell you, offline, I feel like I'm building a friendship with someone, and because it does feel authentic, I don't want to say too much until it just naturally comes out, like kind of like you and Jay. But yeah, I'm excited because I get what you're saying, and that's really cool. How did y'all meet? How did y'all first like become friends? Like, did he come into your life because you were talking about something, and then y'all kept on having like, then it just built, or was it something else?
You know what? I swear I don't even remember. Let me think. I really do not remember. I think I talked about him. I cannot remember though. I really can't. I think I had talked about him, and I think we connected from there because I reached out to him to mm-hmm. ask him a question or something. Mm-hmm. And it just became super genuine from there. Like,
yeah,
we trusted each other, and yeah, it just came from there. But I want to say it may have been it was definitely before the Martell situation, so I don't really remember. I don't remember.
Gotcha.
I'm gonna have to go find.
I always wonder, like, and because it was so natural, I can understand that you don't actually know the exact moment because it wasn't planned on. It was just, so I get that too. I was just wondering because I just be curious about that. Like, I love knowing the beginning. Once you see like this development of something happen, I love knowing how things started. So, but I get not.
No, Miss QT Pie, it was before the reunion. It was way before the reunion because we had garnered enough of a friendship that when what happened to him at the reunion, he called me. So we had been friends before then, but I do know I reached out to him about something. I cannot remember what it was, but I reached out to him about something, and it just became genuine from there. And y'all saying y'all gonna talk about it on Saturday, but if I ask him, he probably gonna say the same thing. He don't remember. Yeah, that's how genuine it was to me. Like, it wasn't really. And I think what I reached out to him about was so minute and small that, mm-hmm. again, I can't remember what it was, but we just began to build a friendship from there.
I got you. Yeah.
Yeah. So he probably going to say the same thing now. Yeah, hey, maybe he will say something different. I jotted down to ask on Saturday. Tell these people how we met, because I don't remember.
I love it. But yeah. Okay, look, my little mini interview. I think
Katrina Johnson said that makes absolutely no sense. What makes absolutely no sense?
Wait, what? No, don't, because see, that's the ones I just skip over. If it's like, if it seemed like that, you just let it go.
Oh no, let's make it.
Okay, Katrina, can you clarify?
Yeah, don't clarify it, honey.
Katrina, please. Like, this is my first time seeing her name in the chat. I think so, Katrina, please. Like, look, we be chill over here, okay?
I've seen Katrina on my channel too. So I like, please tell me what it is that doesn't.
Maybe
make sense.
She might be in a different part of my life. She might not be in real time.
Oh, for no, her to do that.
She clarified though. I don't know.
That makes no sense for her to do that.
I don't know.
Well, we didn't speak about her, so. I don't think she's talking to me. but yeah, so again, I it was a genuine whatever I reached out to him about was probably simple and minute, and we just grew from now.
Oh, Deborah, okay, here's a question for you.
You know, I don't know, we gotta be careful with some of y'all. So I don't know.
If it wasn't in the original plan, do what you planned on doing.
Yeah, I don't know, but that would be a good idea. It would be a good idea. But that's not on the schedule for tomorrow.
Gotcha.
I'll say that. But it might be something that we can incorporate soon. at some point.
I like it. Look, y'all gave me a couple things. I might have to separate the videos to make sure that they see it because the live is long
look
now.
Look at Teresa. Teresa, don't do that. Teresa. Okay. With Jay Jones me about them gummies.
Okay. She is in the past because she's talking about Stormy. I think she's in the past. It's okay.
Oh, okay. You don't want to get cussed out. No, you good. I'm talking about Teresa because remember when Jay was saying that I was a dope fiend, crackhead, whatever you call me, about them gummies, taking them gummies. So,
child. Yes. He's clean.
I'm going to have some tomorrow just for that. So yeah, I'm just excited. We're gonna have a good time. Y'all tune in
Saturday. My apologies. Yes. I know I'm gonna get corrected 1,000 times in the comments later. My apologies. It is not on the same day as Charnita. I got my days mixed up. I was just so excited and thought, oh, it's too good to be true, and I'm gonna miss one. So I'm sorry.
Remember, I originally told you we were gonna do Fridays, but
okay.
And our original plan was to go live like maybe after Charnita. That's what he called me, was a junkie. There you go. Thank you, Daddy. that was our original plan, was to go live like 30 minutes after Charnita's World. But again, like once I start shooting, I'll be shooting mainly like on Fridays and Saturdays.
And go ahead and talk about what you're shooting outside of this too. Go ahead, Chef.
Well,
or is that not the one you talked about already? Is that a separate project? I know you got like 50 projects.
I do have like 50 projects going on. So, this is another exclusive, child. Okay, so as of right now, we have put School of Love on the back burner.
Okay.
We have put that on the back burner. However, there is something else coming soon. I don't want to speak too fast, but there is something else in the works that is coming soon that we'll be shooting. But we also still have Hotline Bling coming up season 2.
Okay.
And then also too, I will be doing the awards show again this year.
Okay.
So last year, in case if you don't know, last year I'm always coming up with ideas, child, always. And so I had came up with this idea, and at the time I had several people working with me, but we came up with this reality TV show, I mean, this reality award show based on reality stars, like just kind of giving them, I don't feel like they get enough credit. And regardless of how we feel about them, they be bringing us entertainment. Because we watch it. We commentate on it. And I feel like they should get awards and do stuff too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I created like a little virtual award show last year. And it did pretty good because I thought it was a crazy idea. But of course, when I brought it to everybody, it was like, that's not a crazy idea. We haven't seen anything like it, so let's do it. So we did it. And the first year was a success. And the second year is going to dominate. I'm just gonna let you guys know that. So yeah, we're working on that. So yeah, I'm super excited.
Okay. I'm excited for you. I'm just going to be here looking at everything going on. And honestly, anytime I see someone that, I'll say our peers, like, so if I see you and you're like being creative, it's inspiring. If I see another content creator that I love and they do something, it's like, oh, look at them. They leveled up. That's inspiring. So I'm looking forward to the things that y'all are doing.
Listen, I really try, and I say this all the time, like, I feel like when we are in such a creative space, right? We're literally in a creative space. And I always feel like, when we think about those things, like just jot them down on paper and at some point just come out and do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's how I had to see it. I was like, I just got to do it in order for it to. And regardless, I'm either going to know if people are going to be receptive to it or they're not. Right. And I wouldn't have known that people have been asking for another award show. So I just think that every time I always jot down an idea, I try my best to execute it. And if I can't, then I'll put it to the side and figure out other resources to help me try to execute it. So
yeah,
it's, you know, and I'm still learning. Lord have mercy, yeah. I'm still learning.
And but, you stepped out into a different box too, because it's not just it's coming to you too, but you're really doing production value level things. So like, absolutely. You know what I mean? Like you're in absolutely. Studio kitchens and like
yeah, like people just don't understand. Like we're really about to really, really start putting out really dope content, and this is coming from studios and just different stuff. And I'll say this: when Jay and I get ready to do what we're gonna do live, that will.
Uh-oh, you went mute again. You went mute again. Are you still there? Chef Don Don.
Yes.
Okay, you said when me and Jay go live, that will, and then the sound cut out.
Oh, I'm sorry. We'll be at a familiar studio.
Okay, cool.
So I promise you guys will enjoy a lot of things that we're doing. I promise you. And yeah, just be on the lookout. Be on the lookout. Yo, let's get it.
I was stuck because I keep trying to think of questions. So go on now. You have to go.
You know how I feel about your voice, so honey. I can talk to you all day. You know how I feel about your voice. I can listen to you all day, honey. Chef Dada's voice sound familiar. Did he do any comedic voiceovers on YouTube? No, I haven't, because I am too country for that.
No, that's the best. They love our country.
I slip up on words, y'all. I be talking about Wanda, but baby, sometimes I be like, man, you can't talk about her because you will butcher a word in a minute. And I sure ain't good with names and stuff. Oh, child.
It's hey, when I come to Texas, Chef, like I said, no promises. But when I come to Texas, and if there is a day, I'm going to be looking for you because, you know, I wasn't an adult there. I went straight to the military at 17, but that's still where I grew up and was raised. So if I come to Texas and you free, I might have to see you if I can, because I'm going to be down there for like 2 weeks. So
listen, I promise you, I ain't no weirdo. You would definitely have a good time. Cause I don't go nowhere. So we will definitely have a good time. And also, too, I'm...
Oh, what happened? Chef, it cut out again.
I cut out again?
Yes, but this is where it cut out. It's not long. You said, and also, too, I'm...
What was I about to say? Oh, I want to plan like a meet and greet where... Okay. We do like some cooking, like you know how they do the paint and sip.
Yeah, yeah.
But we'll do cooking and sip, and yeah. So we're working on that too. When I tell you, I be having a lot going on, and the people just do not realize that I really do.
You do? No, you do. I be like, you be making me tired just thinking about what you have. Like, dang, I be thinking I got some things going on. You out here again, just the filming and production and editing, I just can't imagine. Because just when I be having to think about editing a pre-recorded video, I be like, oh, Jesus.
You know what? I listen. And people, the crazy thing is, this is why I don't really check my DMs often. I only check them from people who, you know, I quite often talk to. Because people are always asking me, well, can you edit this? Can you do this? And I'll be like, girl, I do not have enough time. I'm sorry, I don't.
Can I tell you? So I did one edit for somebody, and shout out to them because they are, you know, great, great person. And they reached out again for something. And I was like, I can't believe I have to say this, but I can't do it. I'm too busy.
when you be doing like, because it's a lot, people don't realize like how much, like just last night I'm editing a cooking video, y'all. The cooking video ain't even 15 minutes and I only got about 3 hours of sleep last night, so, and I'm still not nowhere done with it. That's how much it can be very strenuous, guys. I enjoy it, I do enjoy it, so I'm not complaining. Yep.
I'm over here cheesing.
Yes, I can't complain because I do enjoy it. I do. And I made a lot of sacrifices to learn, so yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I remember I heard you on one of your lives saying you've been taking some formal like training and classes and things to kind of make, you know, better yourself. And I'm like, I get it. That's another commitment.
I actually have one tomorrow.
Oh my gosh.
I actually have one tomorrow. I'm always willing to learn, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm, and I just mm-hmm. be feeling like, you know, you can't fill that tank up too much. So yeah. That's why.
Is YouTube your full-time thing? Like, in the sense of like, do you have to report to an actual employer, or do you just like, I'm a content creator and this is all how it comes? Like, it's all on me.
Yes and no. So I would say 80% yes, 20% no. The 20% of me has a side job that, okay, you know, I have to report to, but I still make my own schedule. I still make my own schedule with this. Okay. So it's still kind of, you know, free, but majority of it is my content. Yeah.
Okay. Gotcha. Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Well. And I love it. I love it. Did I ever think that we would get this far? Mm-mm. But when I remember when I had 500 subscribers, but I was like, girl,
I remember 20.
Baby, remember when I used to go live. I'll give you a show, for example. I don't know if you remember this, but do you remember when Judge Mathis them had their show?
Their family show. Okay, yeah.
The family show. Okay, I remember when I used to review that show. Baby, I used to be on there 25 minutes and ain't nobody came in. everybody was like, just stay consistent. And then that's when I finally started learning how to upload pre-records. Mm. I said, oh no, I'm just gonna start doing pre-records. Y'all ain't gonna keep embarrassing me. But yeah, so like I remember them days, but now that we're here and I'm almost at 11K, it's very shocking to me.
Come on,
very,
very shocking. Everybody. Yes.
Very shocking, because I ain't think it would happen. No lie.
No, you know what? I understand what you're saying, because when I was like, I had a year plan just to get to monetize. Like, if I could just get to monetize, so to think about that is like, okay, I'm just hanging on for the ride.
And they have made it so easy for people to get monetized now. It wasn't the same.
They did. They when sure I got did monetized. Change it. Yep.
Baby.
They made me see the old rules, baby.
You could even go live if you didn't have 100 subscribers, honey.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
So they have changed a lot of rules now from when I first originally started. I can't even believe I've been doing this thing that long. Child. But yeah, so I'm excited for tomorrow, guys. Y'all come with y'all popcorn, come with your candy. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm not saying get no cavities or nothing behind us, but you know, get your candy, get your popcorn, get your hot dogs. You know, get everything.
Hot dogs.
get your hot dogs, your hamburgers, whatever. Meet us.
East Coast and Southern hot dogs, and
you know,
you went straight south.
Okay, so yeah, I'll tell you this. I used to work for DirecTV before they merged with AT&T.
Mm-hmm.
And literally my QA person would come by and say, can you stop mixing your accents, because I think you'd be confused to people. But she was black too, and she was just joking with me. But one day I literally said that, and this lady was like, I can't really make out if you're from Baltimore or if you're from like Alabama or something. I'm like, oh my god. I make it hard for people. I do. I make it hard for people. But I don't know why I'm like that, though. I don't know.
I don't know. I think it just creeps out because when I was deployed to Kuwait, that's when I'm usually... whenever you deploy, you're around people that don't sound like you, right? And so somebody one day, I don't know what I said, but they were like, oh, I'm going to say Trending, but you know, they said my name. They were like, oh, Trending, the Louisiana just came out of you.
It be like that. They be like, where you from? And then when I say Texas, they be like, Texas? Yes, honey, I am from West Texas, so I don't know where some of this stuff done came from.
Now, my Arkansas husband had the nerve to tell me, because I'm Texas, Louisiana, he had the nerve to tell me, he was like, Charnita reminds me of you, or you remind me of Charnita, because y'all got that southern thing. I said, you're from Arkansas. Like, how dare you?
Now, first of all, Arkansas people cannot talk, because y'all know y'all will cut a word off. Y'all know y'all cut words off. My best friend is from Arkansas, and we always have this debate on all of this. I'm like, you act like Arkansas is 20 states up north. Right. It's not. You just right above us, and I mean right beside us, so we know exactly how you talk. Y'all right. Don't finish y'all words.
Don't you ever come from Texas.
And I used to always, and I find myself saying it now, but I used to always laugh at him because he'd be like, if I say wherever somebody is, he'd be like, go check the car. Go check what? Go check the car. The what? Go check the car. And I'm like, you mean the car? Okay, sure. So, a bit with, because of church Sunday, I will at least give Chef. Oh, please do, Mama Capricorn. Please, please do. Please do. And the reason why we got to go late, live later, Mama Capricorn, that's Jay's fault, okay?
Look, not put it on Jay.
That's Jay's fault. I had to throw him under the bus real quick.
I also like the name of y'all's show, because that is exactly what it's going to be. It's giggles. That's what it's going to be. Your audience is going to be giggling. Of course, you, because... Whoever said activate the Google box in your chat, that was so cute. That's exactly what's going to happen.
Okay, can I tell you something about that?
What?
You know when I came up with that name?
When?
At 3:00 this morning when I got woke up out of my sleep.
Oh,
I really felt like, I felt like it was like ordained to happen. So last night I went to sleep like a little frustrated. Well, not last night, this morning. Technically, I went to sleep a little frustrated because I was like, man, I want to find the right title. And mm-hmm. I had been juggling through some stuff. And so I had woke up and I was like, I'm going to go ahead and start meditating and praying now. Mm-hmm. And right after I did, I opened up Adobe and I was just moving some stuff around. And I said, I got it. Saturday Night Giggles, baby. I got it. So that was dope. That was definitely dope. I think it definitely fits us well.
Yeah, I agree. I'm excited. When I told him, when you gave me the exclusive the first time, I was like, congratulations on your show. He said, who said something? Was this shit done? I was like, yeah, he told us.
So, dude, baby, because we have to talk about it now so we can get the people over there.
You can't talk about the day of. Yes.
Yeah, we don't do that. We can at least do the day before, honey. Mm-hmm. At least, child. But not, yeah, I had told people because I felt, well, honestly, you was the only person. Well, of course, your chat. But as far as content creators, you were the only one who
knew. I am so honored. I'm serious, too. I'm not being sarcastic. I'm really honored. I am.
No, I feel like you understand us because mm-hmm. you like to laugh, too. So I feel like you understand us. So that's why I was like,
yeah, that's
I'm
true.
Going to definitely tell Trent.
That's what it is. Having to defend your laugh is probably...
I mean, I heard Chef Dot I get to go about something. He haven't finished his show. I can't, y'all. If I get too tickled, I ain't finishing nothing.
Yeah.
They used to pop up lives on mail. Mm.
Or is he saying they used to pop up in? I think Joe might be saying, did they used to pop up in your live? Is that what she's saying? Jay used to pop up in lives with mail, like your lives. Did they ever pop up in your lives?
Oh, yeah, they have several times. Both of them have. Mm-hmm. like even when I'm like not interviewing Jay, mail has stopped in.
Yeah.
From love several times, you know.
I have a meme I'm posting about mail popping up in lives because I be losing my mind.
Baby, listen, I have always said, don't nobody come up in my life that's of any type of importance, because I will, like, fan out just because that's how I am. I just love people, so I'm like, not you in my chat.
Yeah, it's something like,
I even do that with YouTubers, like other YouTubers.
I'm like,
what you doing over here?
Right.
Especially some big ones, the big YouTubers. I'm like, not you over here in my little old chat.
Like, let that, as much as I talk to Chit Chat, let Chit Chat come in my live, or Lord, if Queen Sheba stop in my live, Diana Rose, when she does, I'm like, hey, what you can't be here, but what are you doing?
Baby, true tea. What's happening? When they be coming up in my life, I be like, what y'all doing over here?
True tea came. Oh my gosh. Yes, it's like at that point, y'all just, it went off the rails. Don't hold it against me. I can't do anything about this.
Yeah, I be like that. I do. my hands were literally shaking when Mel let me up on her IG live. Child wouldn't know what to do. I've been like, Jay, how you turn this live on?
You done forgot how to use the app.
Yes. I'm like that with people, period, though. Like, because I admire a lot of people, you know, so I just, I be fanned out.
Yeah. Look, you about to make me get into some of that imposter syndrome talk. But I'm telling you, like, look, I'm about to say thank you now to people that just be here supporting. And we just, like, when we were at our 20 and at our 500 and everything, thank y'all, because y'all will be here entertained with no foundation. Just, like, let me stick around.
And I love that. I literally love that, where you could just have fun with your people. Your people just here giggling with you, honey.
Yes. Are you going to be at the thing? Are you going to Mimosas with Mel? I know you're so busy. Are you going though?
No, I'm not. I wanted to go, but that date won't work.
Gotcha. I did say that if she puts MeloCon on the weekend of my family reunion, my family going to be mad at me because I done made a choice.
Now, I ain't gonna lie, I would definitely be there to the MeloCon, but I'ma just, listen, this is what I got to tell y'all Melometers, okay? Let me tell y'all this.
Wait, you talking to the reasonable ones, you know that, right?
I know. I just don't want y'all to beat me up, okay? Don't beat me up if I come to MeloCon, okay? Please don't beat me up, y'all.
Oh, we won't.
Okay? I always have to ask the Melometers not to beat me up because I know some of y'all, boy, y'all.
Chef, you gonna have a nice old wall of reasonable Melometers that got your back. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. We got you.
Listen, that's why they talk about. Is that really why you didn't go to Huntsville? Yes, I'm scared of the Melometers.
No. I'm glad. Okay. Oh, she said, aren't violent. I was like, what, purple queen? But she said, are not violent.
Y'all, please don't get me. Don't get me. But no, I really hope that I can go to MeloCon. I do. I really hope for that.
I hope so, too. We got to start getting on her nerves about a date so we can start planning.
Yes, because, and Yes, we definitely need a date. We definitely yeah. need a we definitely need a date. And I'm just ready for whatever. But yeah, I wish I was going to Mimosas with Mel, because them speakers, my God.
Right.
I mean, listen, are you going?
Yeah, we were actually talking about outfits. They reminded me I need to get a clutch purse because I forgot about that. So yeah, we were talking. Yes, I am going.
Listen, this is what I got to say to y'all that's getting the opportunity. And I'm going to say this. The reason why I admire Mel so much is because of just her business mindset. Like, to me, she's a marketing genius. Like, and I don't say that lightly. You know, there are very few people who I feel like know what to do with what they have, right? And I feel like Mel is just that girl that knows what to do with what she has. So, them speakers, listen, y'all better take some notes and stuff and come on back and talk to me, because I love it. I just love it. I love every bit of it.
Yep. Yes.
Come on, speakers. Yeah, y'all better make out some millions, honey. From these millionaires.
Can I tell you? Hold on, let me tell you. This is how trolly my husband is. He called me while I was on live talking to you. So I said, hey, I'm on live. Are you okay? He said, nah, do your live trending. Don't check on me. I'm about to be on Kendra G in a little bit looking for somebody.
Baby, he got you with that one. He got you good.
I'm so good. I need he to got make you sure good. At least I
that is so funny. Not Kendra G.
What?
The fact that
you know about it, because I've been binge watching her.
You, oh my gosh, Trendy, we be having so much in common. I sit back and I watch, and I ain't gonna lie to you. I be kikiing at some of them people. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Y'all talking about a tickle box, a giggle box. That would give me a giggle box. Especially when the epic one when that man came up there, she was like, how old are you? And he was like 27. And she was like, no, I'm asking you, how many years have you been on Earth? And he was like, you heard me. I said, that is the funniest one to me. I'm sorry, but that when I need a good laugh, I go look that up. That is hilarious. he was so mad.
He was a hard 25. If that man was 25, he had a hard.
He was so mad. He was so mad.
Oh my God.
I promise y'all need a good nah. If you watch it live and read them comments, baby.
Yeah, the comments go too far sometimes. They be too mean.
Yeah, them comments, everybody gay, everybody this, everybody that.
Right.
So you got to go watch the ones that she upload. Yes, you got to watch the ones she uploads separately. They'll be the funny ones.
Golden Life
he did. Baby, I almost ate it because...
I'm going to pull up the thumbnail. Hold on. Try to find it.
Oh, my God. And when he came home, he just knew it was going to go well. Hey, Kendra.
Oh, I think, look, YouTube already know. I think it auto-completed. Yep, here you go.
Okay. Oh, God, here we go. Lord, help me.
I'm just going. Oh, you know what? I'm going to keep it on pause. It was only 4 minutes. That's how fast he went off of it. It was so mad.
Wait, and then he said, I know you're not talking, sitting up here looking like Tasha K. y'all gotta see it.
Let me get the link so y'all can get this. And just know, if you've never seen Kendra G, she is very confident in herself. So it is pure laughs because this man was so mad.
He was so bad. And Kendra G did not care. Oh my gosh. When you play Cora running, I fall out. Child, she ought to be shamed.
He said he don't look 29, Pamela.
He don't look 20 nothing. 30 nothing, 40 nothing. 50 maybe. Said, look at people you? Chris about who grandpa is that. See. Yeah, he's 27.
Oh man.
He 27, honey. Y'all gotta get into that video. I promise y'all will have a great
That's key. A good laugh. It's short too. It's short.
Oh man. It is hilarious. It is hilarious.
Oh, April said she done it.
Listen, I love a good key. So y'all say some giggles.
Okay.
He just stopped. Roger. Oh my God, that is hilarious.
You know, Kevin Hart thing is like, when Don Cheadle was like, I'm 50, so he's like, damn.
It's Kevin G talking about. He said, I'm 27.
She's a YouTuber, y'all. Her is literally Kendra G on YouTube. And I dropped the actual link to this video if you want to see it. But her name is Kendra G. That's her channel.
Let me see. She be doing a data, like a Instagram
data. Yeah, single.
Yeah. Baby. Y'all want a good laugh? Go look at some of the. Yeah, Roger do need to have a seat because that was hilarious. Kendra stopped talking for a minute. She did. You still looking at him talking about. No, no, no. I mean, how many years have you been on this earth? And that's where he went off.
Oh, y'all. And just go, you know, if you're ready, you need to, if you never been, just go to videos and go watch the highlights. Under her videos is the highlights. That's what it's just. It could be some of anything. Listen, as you can see, I've been all up in this
thing. Baby, when I promise you, when I need a good laugh, I will go key. Or maybe not necessarily a good laugh, but sometimes some of them folks' situation be out of this world. You be like, are you really looking for somebody? Like, yes.
Yes. Sorry, I brought this back up. I'll try not to name them. I be trying not to stereotype people, but sometimes I just be like, oh my God.
That would be fun. That would be fun. That's a great idea, actually. That's a great idea.
Oh, y'all get y'all thing and then just put me in a slot one day. But I know y'all got to get y'all thing off the ground. Ain't gonna be true, but you already know. I would say yes if you ever ask. I would say yes.
I would love it though. Yes. That would be fun. That would definitely be fun. I told y'all trending understand us. Trending like the laugh. I love people that like to laugh.
I love to laugh. Okay. All right.
All right, y'all. Well, listen, I'll say this. Y'all meet us tomorrow night.
Back up. Hold on.
9:45 Eastern and 8:45 Central Time. And again, if you wonder why it's so late, we're going to blame it on Jay. Okay, it's not my fault. It's not my fault at all.
Because you're not busy, right? Right, I'm not going to have no words. They going to be like, we don't like her on here because she ain't even saying nothing. She adds nothing to the conversation.
Yo, why she laughing at everything that they say? Listen, y'all, if we have more of this in life, I think we would be in such a better place. We need to laugh more. There's a lot going on. And so we do need to laugh more. So y'all get your giggle box ready. If you do not have your giggle box ready, don't come in the chat, okay? Until you have your giggle box ready, then you can come in the chat and kiki with us, okay? Because y'all going to have a good time.
Chef, I'll be ready. I'm gonna set my alarm. Thank you for coming up and just chit or like talking and everything and giggling with me.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Wait. If you turn that 27 around to 72, that's more believable. Toya, I need you to go to bed early. Toya, not turning around and making 72.
That man is retired. I don't know what
you out of control for that one. Okay, y'all. Listen, again, tune in. The link should be available this evening, so we'll start sharing it around.
Okay. We'll be on the lookout. Y'all all remind me if you don't see me over there.
Good Friday.
Bye, Chef. Oh, y'all, please support Chef Don Don. I can't. Oh, my gosh. We'll end it here because I'll keep y'all forever.
Can you hear me now? I was just saying, y'all have a good Friday.
You too, Chef.
All right. Bye.
Bye. Y'all. Okay. All right. I got to let y'all go because you know I'm going to see you tonight for the Charnita Watch Alone. Then I got to say, somebody said take a nap so I can be ready for Chef Don Don and Jay's live tomorrow night. I will do my best. Yes, this is amazing. Thank you so much, Chef Don Don, for sharing y'all's new show with us. Oh my gosh, y'all. Yep. One day it's gonna be a giggle special guest on there when they ready, you know, because like I said, I'll be trying to take in nobody's space when they, you know, I just want to be there when it's natural, it's okay. But I would love to be on there. Hold on, I gotta call. Oh my god, y'all. All right. See y'all later. I'll cut out the melody. Live, so you can just see that, and then I'll also probably cut out the Chef Don Don at Jay Taylor's announcement. So thank you so much. Please just support the content creators. All right, y'all, love y'all. Bye. Other taking all your time.